to start this, a late start here at Nathan Shapell Stadium. Game time was supposed to be at 1 o'clock, but we're glad you're with us. Fullerton College on the offensive side of the ball when they get the ball. The offensive line center is going to be Nathan Trent. He's joined by Emil Graves, Delton Crandall, Muhammad Jefferson, and Marshall Levins up front for the Hornets.
And don't forget, right after this game, a big game on SportsnetUSA.net. The franchise, Rashawn Haylock. Golden West College takes on Saddleback. Saddleback undefeated. Fullerton undefeated. So you'll get two games today with undefeated teams here on SportsnetUSA.net. Back deep, DeAndre McNeil is going to be back deep. And standing next to him, Justin Mannyweather. So they're back deep for the Hornets, who are going to receive to start off this first half for a little Fullerton College football on SportsnetUSA.net in conjunction with Fullerton College TV.
Grossmont, the Griffins, will have on defense when they come out Ryden Kerr, Cameron Myers, Quantarius Boone, Ike Puamele, Roderick Woods, Jordan Ellis, Narquise Smith, Hunter Clark, Alex Carswell, and James Julius on defense. Their starting linebacker, Tyler Clanton, may not see action today.
Officials are out on the field. Have six officials out there. They finally showed up. You know, that'll just show you, don't take rapid transit here in Orange County. It'll get you to the game late. Guys, you were supposed to take the 49 to the 35 to the 78, and that bus would have dropped you off here on Bass and Cherry. But since that's happened and they're here, let's start with a little Fullerton College football on SportsnetUSA.net. Hornets 5-0, Grossmont 4-1. First conference game for either team. Winner goes away with a smile. Loser is looking uphill. Mannyweather takes it right at the goal line, up to the 10. 15, 20, hits the 20, stays on his feet, across the 20, down at the 22.
There was a punch thrown after.
Mannyweather on the return.
I want to see what happened at the bottom of that pile. Tackle made by Gabe Boyler.
On the tackle. First down, Fullerton on their own 20.
So they've got it marked at the 23. It'll be first down and 10 at the 23.
And the other starting linebacker will be Cole Kidd for the Griffins.
Jordan Hoy comes in at quarterback. Hewlett, the deep setback. Fullerton, once again, Jordan Hoy having an outstanding season. Puts Grossman in motion from left to right. Drops the ball, picks it up, can't find it, finds it. He's in trouble, taken down, flag on the play. And that started as ugly as it can get for the Hornets on the first play against Grossmont.
And we'll see what the flag is. But again, low snap, couldn't really get off. And it looks like Grossmont, the Griffins are coming in. Three down linemen, four linebackers, but they will mix it up from time to time.
So that's going to take it all the way back to the 14-yard line. Jerome Gross out wide to the right. Grossman in the slot on the right-hand side. Justin Walker out wide to left. Shotgun formation against with Jordan Hoy. Hewlett in the backfield. Second down and a long 17 yards. Hewlett rolls out against pressure. Throws it over there. Taken out of the air by Jerome Gross. Gross turns the corner at the 40. It's a foot race at the 50. Oh, just gets tripped up at the 40-yard line. Jerome Gross made it a foot race and almost won the race.
Narquise Smith knocks him down. Gross was on the way. I didn't know he had that much speed with him. He just outran the defensive backs.
Walker out to left. Grossman in the slot. Hewlett goes in motion from left to right. Jordan Hoy by himself. Time goes across the middle. Throws it to Walker. Incomplete pass. Thrown there to Justin Walker. 6'5", just couldn't pull it down.
54-yard pass play to Gross on that last play. This one, there's a flag on the play. We'll see what it is. But again, good coverage by the Griffins, James Julius.
Illegal chop block against the Hornets, and maybe that's why Grossmont has a player down.
And you see the replay right there. Right as the ball meets Walker's hands, there's Julius to dislodge the ball. Cameron Myers is down, starting defensive lineman, 6'2", 260 out of Stafford, Virginia.
So that's going to move the Hornets back with a chop block. Pop Hornets Thomas down, now comes in at running back. Robert Johnson out wide to the left. Grossman in the slot on the left-hand side. Pop Thomas in the backfield with Jordan Hoy. Pop takes it, gets hit. Welcomed at the line of scrimmage and can't get away.
And good push up front by the Griffins. Ike Puamele is there first for the Griffins to bring him down. Tackle behind the line of scrimmage. And Puamele, that's his fifth tackle for loss this season.
Second down and 16 for the Hornets. Out wide to the right is going to be Asante Wilder. Outside of him on the right-hand side is going to be Justin Walker. Jordan Hoy in a shotgun formation. Second down and 16 for the Hornets, right at the 49. Jordan Hoy has time. Gets caught, spins away, gets away from it, and then flips it up. Taken right there as the tight end, Corey, comes back and helps out. And Christian Williams bills Jordan Hoy out.
Yeah, that's one of the best eight-yard plays. Here's the replay, one of the best eight-yard pass plays you'll see. But again, it wasn't Puamele that time. That was Quantarius Boone who put the pressure on Hoy. Hoy backs out. He's one of those 70s tearaway breakaway jerseys. And then he gets it over to Williams for 8 yards, and Fullerton has some life.
Third down and 20, Phillip Butler now in the backfield. Grossmont coming with everybody. They hand it off to Butler up the middle. Butler at the 30. It's a foot race. 20, stays on his feet. Oh, taken down. Phillip Butler just gets taken down at the end.
Here's the problem. What I wanted to say in the open, Fullerton running backs should have a big game today. And now I can't even say it.
First and goal for the Hornets.
Butler went over 100 yards last year against Grossmont.
Butler says, well, you know what, guys? Give it to me again. Gets down. It's going to be marked down at the 2.
Just a strong run on that right side of that offensive line. That's Emil Graves and Muhammad Jefferson on that right side. He went 2 yards past, or 2 runs past, for over 40 yards on 2 carries. That's a pretty good average.
Hewlett comes in at running back. Sean McConnell is going to be the up back in an I formation. Hewlett the deep setback. They hand it. Jordan Hoy fakes it, takes it to the corner. Touchdown, Fullerton College, and a flag as Jordan Hoy was way out of bounds and gets knocked down by Grossmont. So with 12 to go, Grossmont shows her colors, but Jordan Hoy's athleticism gets him into the end zone.
Yeah, and if you have a replay on that, you'll see the just put the ball right in the gut of Hewlett, brought it out, and that's the easiest 6 of the year for Jordan Hoy. Here's your replay. Under center, and fakes the handoff to Hoy, fakes everybody out. He keeps it on the bootleg. Jordan Hoy, as a rusher, he's got 17 yards or 17 touchdowns passing. As a rusher, that's his 5th of the season.
We've got a delay because there's a lengthy discussion by the officials in the corner. Corey, Jordan Hoy was over there, knocked out of bounds, and now they're still talking about the flag.
Oh, it should be unnecessary roughness after the dead ball foul.
Well, there was a second flag that came out because when Jordan Hoy ran by the Grossmont player, he was clapping, and I think they're going to call taunting.
They are going to call taunting because they put the ball up, so they're not going to. And then they call a personal foul, so it's going to be offsetting penalties. So the offense, it was on the bench after they scored. They call a taunting play.
So the score's taken off the field.
Yeah, score's taken off the board. So offsetting penalties. Taunting by Hoy as he put the ball up.
But how can Fullerton use yardage? They lost yardage on the play. They were at the 3. They're now at the 7. How can they lose yardage if it's an offsetting penalty? They're calling it a dead ball foul then on the taunting. But you still would mark it further back. The officials
let me answer that question.
Okay.
Maybe. So it shouldn't have been taunting because they didn't call the penalty. They didn't throw the flag right when he taunted the defense. They threw the penalty after the late hit.
I don't get where the ball's marked.
I love this set. Four running backs on the field at the same time. Here's Hewlett, hands off to Pop Thomas, looking for a block, cuts it up the middle, running hard. Touchdown,
Fullerton College.
I'm sorry, I took that over.
That's okay. They went for two, so that's what it was, Corey. They went for two. They went for 2 points, so we thought it was on the penalty. So you're going to see the Hornets go for two. Pop Thomas has it. Wait, hesitates. Then goes back, keeps moving, and goes down. So the confusion was they went.
Wait, if they went for two.
No, if they went for two, why would they be kicking a field goal? You can't. I don't understand the rule on the field. So I was right on the first call.
Okay.
It was a touchdown. We need clarification from the officials.
So technically, the score now is Fullerton 9. I'll go handle this.
So they called unsportsmanlike conduct because Jordan Hoy held the ball like the Statue of Liberty going into the end zone. They called unsportsmanlike conduct because he held the ball like the Statue of Liberty and marked it from there. My partner got me off the air, and I usually don't, am held in contempt for the officials. I still think somewhere down on the field, I would have to look at the rule book on that one because I've never seen a rule like that called. But at this stage of the game, it doesn't matter. It's the Hornets 7. Grossmont 0. Big kickoff. Taken right there. Taken out of the air by Brown. Brown lets it go out of bounds. And we get another flag on the play. So the ball goes.
Kick out of bounds.
Out of bounds. So the ball went out of bounds. And Corey, if you had an explanation, I'll let you tell it on the air.
Okay.
Corey, explain this.
They called taunting on Jordan Hoy before he crossed the goal line. But the flag was thrown after he crossed the goal line, and there was a late unnecessary hit by Grossmont. The second flag came in for the taunting call. So since they're calling taunting before he crossed the line of scrimmage, crossed the goal line, they bring that back. That touchdown does not count. So Fullerton, that's actually the correct rule, but to bring it back. Fullerton brings in their four running backs and scores the touchdown on the next play. Extra point is good.
So it's the Hornets 7, Grossmont 0. Cagle throws it out in the flat. Quickly taken out in the flat by Adrian Tolbert. Tolbert's had a great season. He averages 104 yards a year.
Now here was where Mark gets it. It should have been offsetting penalties. The ball should not have been moved out back at all. It should have been
original line of scrimmage.
At the original line of scrimmage.
Yeah, that's where the officials confused both of us. They moved it out. They marked a penalty against the Hornets that should not have happened. First down and 10. Well, we're catching up with new math here on SportsnetUSA.net.
Offensive line for Grossmont, Evan Pumphrey, Francisco Saavedra, Marco Fowler, Adapana Amosa, and Jabril Cluis.
So the sticks got moved, saying it was a first down. Now they're resetting it for a second down. So everybody started off a little shaky in this 100th homecoming here on SportsnetUSA.net.
We're going to have to go down to Ryan to see what he says about that first drive for Fullerton, if he has anything interesting for us later.
Cagle at quarterback. Brown the deep setback. They hand it off to Brown. Brown goes off left tackle. Tries to slither his way to the right side. Gets almost up to the 50.
And Fullerton defense is set as Jose Bermejo, Quentin Yance, Dominic Sanchez, and Tyler Stepney up front. Linebackers Roy Otto gets the start along with Robert Sanko and Justin Parcells. In the secondary, Tim Gordon, Deshaun Taylor, Jovan Burris, and D'Angelo Ross in the secondary.
Cluis goes out wide to the right. Cagle goes back. Throws it quickly over in the flat. Taken here by Spradling. Spradling turns the corner, stays on his feet, gets a nice gain across the 50, down to the 45.
Tim Gordon on the stop. Justin Parcells comes on over to help.
Dylan Spradling, only averaging 10 yards a game, but he's an important part. They're going to shuttle the receivers inside and out for this team. Nehemiah Brown comes back in at running back. Brown, the deep setback. Cagle under center. Waiting, Fullerton comes up. Cagle hands it off to Brown. Brown gets by the first attack. The second attack gets a gain of one. We get a flag on the play, and it's going to be against the Hornets. D'Angelo Ross gets a flag.
And if you have a replay of that whole thing, here's a replay from Brown getting across. They're going to call targeting on Quinton Yauntz as he was going down. We didn't really see what D'Angelo Ross did at the end of there, but it must be a push in the back, and he's coming out of the game. Coming in for him will be Taj Jones.
Face mask against the Hornets. Personal foul against the Hornets.
So what you're saying, Mark, is this is a typical Grossmont Fullerton game.
Yeah, it is. And it's typical when you're down on the sideline right now and you watch on this play, Corey, and as he hits the line, they're going to get a face mask right there. His head turns. No?
No.
Yeah, I think, no, they called the face mask on that first little turn. There's not a face mask at the end is what they call.
I think they're going to call it when Quinton Yauntz came over on the Amaya Brown and hit
the
head.
They get the personal foul against the Hornets. The Hornets are marked
D'Angelo
off.
Ross.
D'Angelo Ross, 30 yards on that play. So Grossmont says, thank you for the present. We'll take it, even though it's not her birthday. Clueless goes out wide to left. Then the slot on the left-hand side is going to be Spradling. Cagle under center. Brown in the backfield. Brown leads forward. That should be a flag. Throw over to Spradling. Spradling gets hit right at the 10 and taken down. And Brown was, Corey, Brown was rocking forward as if he was in a rocking chair for Grossmont.
Official thought he was going to call it, but he held his hanky in the pocket. Here's a replay. And good coverage by Deshaun Taylor there, wrapping up.
Tolbert goes out wide to the right. Benzant goes out wide to the left. Split backfield for Grossmont. Cagle under center. Rolls out. Here comes the pressure. Cagle gets hit as soon as he throws it. And he is clocked on that as it gets taken down at the 10-yard line. Nice little catch by Marshall Falk Jr. So Marshall Falk Jr., the very little used fullback, gets a nice little catch, brings up a third down and five for the Griffins. Third down and five at the 10. Clueless goes out wide to the left. Tight formation on the right-hand side with Goose. Now he goes in motion from right to left. They hand it off to Brown. Brown tries to cut. He stays on his feet. Two, three missed tackles. Push from behind in the end zone. Touchdown, Grossmont. And the ball came out, Fullerton said, we had it, and they're calling
Brown
touchdown.
Grossmont.
As you see on the replay, they're going to say Brown crossed the goal line before the ball came loose. Tim Gordon is there. D'Angelo Ross is there. Ray Otto is there. They're trying to strip, and that's why he keeps moving forward.
Ball's out.
Yeah, the ball was out, and we can't really tell definitively if he crossed the line of scrimmage or not, or excuse me, the goal line or not, so keep the six.
So four big penalties against the Hornets here with 9:11 to go in the first quarter, and Grossmont takes advantage. Ball is fumbled. Grossmont goes down, takes him down, and you, boy, I thought you might get a flag on that, Corey, as they go after Ledsema and take him down, and I thought they had him by the shoulder hats for a horse collar.
Daniel Robinson with the tackle.
Hornet 7, Grossmont 6.
Ice. And there's a bad snap, and here's Robinson to come through and just fling him down. And the extra point is no good.
So this is what happens when you're official and you sleep a little late. Your alarm clock doesn't wake you up on time. You got sleep in your eye. You're trying to call a game, and you're going, flag on you, and a flag on you, and Corey, no.
They just got to get ready. You know, they weren't into it yet. So the first couple series and just practice series for the officials.
So as we look with 9-11 to go here in the first quarter, is Ryan down on the sideline? Ryan, you down there?
Yeah, he's going to get to us in a second. After the kickoff, we'll go down to Ryan Osborne on the sideline.
So McNeil back deep. Manny Weathers standing next to him. Boy, we still hear the official talk down to our left.
And Fullerton Special Teams also has a chance to break one.
McNeil gets it. following Mannyweather. McNeil sidesteps, gets hit, goes down again, doesn't even get back to the 15.
McNeil return brought down by number 50, Garcia.
Hey, Ryan, what's the talk down in the field about these officials?
From Fullerton College, the big thing is that Jordan Hoy was pressured three times. We talked to Coach Trevor Waters earlier this week on the coaches show. He said the biggest thing for Fullerton College on the offensive line, they have to get that first punch. They have to keep the defensive line of Grossmont off guard and on their heels. If not, Fullerton College is going to have some trouble. Back to you guys.
All right, Jordan Hoy brings it back out. Pop Thomas in at running back. So we'll see what Jordan does. The pressure was there. See if that offensive line can respond like Ryan Osborne was talking about. Jordan Hoy goes back, has time to throw. Steps up, across the middle of the field, up in the air, intercepted by Grossmont. What a wonderful little pick by Cole Kidd.
Pass intercepted by Kidd.
So Hoy, as you see, tried to force it, and his receiver just wasn't in position. Good defense by Narkee Smith. And Kidd driving down to the ground and making the interception, got his hands underneath it. The third interception thrown by Jordan Hoy this season.
Well, we've said that the Hornets have not played from behind yet this year. We'll see how they respond if that happens. Tolbert goes out wide to left in the slot. Cagle at quarterback. First down and 10 at the 35. Cagle goes back. Here comes the pressure. Tries to roll away. And Cagle is smothered at the 45.
Ray Otto getting his first start. Robert Sanka, Tyler Stepney. There's a flag on the field. And the coaches are on the field. They have to get Tyler Stepney. We don't know what's going on out there. And Fullerton, the officials need to get on this right now.
And there is shoving and pushing going on. And the coaches for both teams, Corey, not just Grossmont, both team, the coaches are on the field.
Well, at first it was Grossmont. The official came out and got in Tyler Stepney's face. And now there's penalty. Stepney's helmet flew off. And he was clapping as he comes back after the big sack.
And we, you know, unfortunately, you see a game against two very good football teams. You don't want to determine it. Corey, we're going to get a back judge that is going to get talked about in this game by these coaches because she was the one that threw the second flag. And I think that flag is against the Hornets. And you got the coaches pointing at each other across the field right now.
And we were looking for a replay, and Ryan's going to have something for us later on this little melee. This takes you back down to 2003, Mark.
Yeah, it does.
2004, where Southern California championship between Grossmont and Fullerton couldn't even finish the game because tensions ran high, and there was a brawl on the field.
So with 8:50 to go, it's the Hornets 7, the Griffins 6. You're watching Fullerton College Football on SportsnetUSA.net in conjunction with Hornet TV. We want to thank Hornet Television, Fullerton College Television. They have shown us everything so far in this game, and we hope you're at home. Now they're picking up the flag, Corey.
Ryan!
So the Grossmont coach came on the field. They picked it up. Now Tim Burns is going out there saying, why do you pick up the flag? So Grossmont has had a couple calls that if you're a Grossmont fan, you're happy. If you're a Hornet fan, you're not happy, Corey, as Tolbert comes out wide to the right.
So you see the replay here, and everybody's on the field, and unfortunately, we couldn't see exactly what happened in the scrum.
So they go back deep down the middle for Tolbert as we get a new quarterback, as it's Spencer Moyer on the field, and now we're getting more. And these officials, Corey, need to take control of the football game.
Ryan, what you got for us?
Mr. Osborne.
Here on the field is that Fullerton College wanted to gauge the situation before they went onto the field. The Grossmont coaches were right in front of the official's face, but before anybody from the Fullerton sideline went onto the field, they made sure that the flag was thrown so that way they weren't penalized beforehand. Back to you guys.
All right, Ryan. And Ryan, next time, get us an update on what happened down there in that scrum. We'll hear from you next time.
Third down and 20. Smith goes out wide to the right. Moyer goes back, hands it off in the middle. Take in there. Off around the 35. So Keith Fulton gets up to the 35. It's going to bring up a fourth down and 10 at the 35 for the Griffins.
Good job of getting some of that yardage back. Now you have an opportunity for a long field goal. Or are you going to go for it? Instead of third down and 21, now you got a manageable fourth and 11.
Vincent goes out wide to the left. Smith comes out wide to the right. Fulton in at running back. Moyer, backup quarterback in the game. Fourth down, 11. Moyer comes back, sidesteps, tries to get away. Moyer gets taken down, and the Hornets get it. And again, as there is a scrum behind the play, and Corey, I don't care what team you're on right now. If you're an official, you got to start ejecting players if this is going to continue for either team.
Yeah, and that's Amosa, and it looked like it was Jamichael Moore.
So first down and 10 for the Hornets. And I tell you, if you're Trevor Waters, you've got to calm down your offensive line. If you're Brian Crooks, you've got to recenter your defensive team on the field for the Hornets. Jordan Hoy brings him out. Phillip Butler at running back. Out wide to the right is Justin Walker. Justin Walker goes out wide to the right. Devontae Richardson comes out wide to the left. First down and 10 at the 35. It has been a fist fight in the first quarter. They run a reverse. It's a flea flicker. All by himself is Williams. Christian Williams at the 40, the 30, the 20, the 10. Touchdown, Hornets.
And a double reverse flea flicker is the play. We haven't seen those trick plays for a while. You were out of practice this week.
I saw him at practice, and if Ryan Osborne, we got to go back down to sideline because Ryan Osborne, we've been seeing this all week long in practice.
And I know we're going to have a replay on that one, but Christian Williams, his second touchdown of the season. Hoy hands off to Butler, and here's just a quick reverse. Here's Walker going to come through. No. Get it back to Hoy, and he has time to set his feet. Hands on the stripes. On the laces, and there's Williams all alone. And Christian Williams is faster than we've seen in a long, long time. Dare I say the best tight end since Jason Vanderveer in a Hornet uniform?
You can. Ball is spotted. Aguilar puts it through. And with 7:37, the Hornets pick it up again. Guys, I don't know if you can get me Ryan Osborne on the sideline, but Ryan, if you're down there listening, you and I went out to practice all week long and watched this and said, when will you use this? Corey, teams are upset. Teams are upset, and so what do? You take advantage of people being tweaked on the field and run a trick play.
Yeah, motors and attention and testosterone running high, you got to cool that down, and that's what Fullerton did. Now let's see if both teams can get back to normal and make their plays. Again, it's well executed. The offensive line has to do the blocking. Phillip Butler sells the run initially. Justin Walker is there, but the sail of the run by Phillip Butler makes that play happen.
Brown and Clueless back deep for the Griffins, who get burned on a trick play against the Hornets. And the Hornets are back up by 7 with 7:37 to go. There's more action in this first quarter than there are in some 12 football games. Clueless is going to take it at the 5. Clueless comes up, goes outside, gets hit, breaks a tackle, gets away from 2, gets away from 3. Clueless refuses to go down and is finally drugged down at the 29.
D'Angelo Ross in on the stop along with.
And you watch Clueless go back again. Clueless is going to take it at 5, and Clueless has got great stature to himself, follows his blockers well, goes up the middle court. That initial hit, he breaks. And that gives him an additional 9 yards on the play.
Paul Sims didn't go down low enough to stop Clueless. He hit him shoulder high, head high, and he didn't have the opportunity to wrap up. He comes down just a little bit lower across the waist. he brings them down and they don't gain that extra 5 yards.
Tolbert comes out wide to the right. Moyer still in at quarterback. Moyer runs a little screen, flips it over quickly to Fulton. Fulton takes off, needs a block at the 50, at the 40. Little high stepping as a nice screen pass, a center screen pass by the Griffins work against the Hornets.
And just an excellent play. How do you quell the offense, or excuse me, the defense attack they're coming through? You run with screen play and you get open. While the rush is past the screen play, he gets big yards over 30.
Moyer goes back, steps back, quick little pass, throws a little low on that. Moyer had time and just get it to Spradling, who misses it on that one. So Fulton's in the backfield. Moyer, the backup quarterback, is now in the game. Fulton comes out. Brown comes back in.
And Mark, we'll see if Fullerton changes up their defense just a little bit on this drive. They're very aggressive, and that front four is getting a lot of push. So you may see those draw plays and those screen plays from the Griffins.
Javon Walker and Murray out wide to the right for the Griffins. Walker goes in motion from right to left. They hand it off to Brown. Brown goes against the traffic, misses one tackle, gets enough and squirms his way for the gain of about two. It's going to bring up a third down and 7.
And you watch Brown right here. Gets past the arm tackle of Stepney, but Justin Parcells, the team's leading tackler, is there to wrap up. Bermejo helps on the back end, and instead of a huge gain, maybe 6, 7, third and short, they've got a 3rd and 6.
6:43 to go. Tolbert goes out wide to the right. Brown up tight behind Moyer. Here they come. Throw it over to the flat. Taken, and I think it's going to be a catch that's good enough as Clueless, as it hits the ground. Clueless thought he had his body around the ball for a possible first down.
You got the replay here.
Pass broken up by number 3.
It's a low throw.
So it brings up a 4th down and 7. As we see, Clueless thought he had it. Moyer comes back over. Brown in at running back. Clueless goes out wide to left. Spradling Dillon out in the slot on the left-hand side. Brown sneaks up behind Moyer. Here come the Hornets. They're going to go again that way again. Looking to throw it deep. Overshoots him. And pressure be the guide. That's what made Moyer throw it a little too quick on that play.
Yeah, and they had decent coverage. D'Angelo Ross was late on the come-up to Clueless, but there was a corner route one-on-one with the safety, Deshaun Taylor. Here's your replay. As it was Dillon Spradling they were looking for, had a step on Taylor, but it was just slightly overthrown. Fullerton College, the second 4th down stop they've had today.
So it'll be 1st down and 10 for the Hornets at the 36. 6:22 to go here in the first quarter. The Hornets are up by 8. It's Fullerton 14, Grossmont 6. Jordan Hoy comes in, looks at the referee, talks to him. McNeil out wide to the left, trying to get the time. Hoy feeling a little bit more comfortable. Looks like they're bringing a weak side blitz. They do. Give it to Pop Thomas. Pop can't get away. Wrestled down, and Pop Thomas is just eaten alive in the backfield.
And Pop Thomas still moving. Best 5 yard loss we've seen this year. Here's the replay. They just shoot the gap on the A and the B.
Robert Johnson goes out wide to the right. Grossman in the slot on the right-hand side. McNeil out wide to the left. Jordan Hoy. Pop Thomas now goes from left to right, goes back to the left. 2nd down and 13. Hoy taking his time. Here comes the blitz. Hoy has it as a feet, picks it up, sidesteps, looks for a place to run to. Sidesteps one. Jordan Hoy dances his way. Oh, I'm Fred Astaire. Little light-footed shuffle down the field. Maybe a little more like Gene Kelly going down the field for Jordan Hoy.
Or for you younger folks, Savion Glover going down the field and getting that first down for the Hornets.
1st down and 10 at the 48. Hoy says, hey, I'm hearing the music. Let's keep dancing. Puts Pop in motion from left to right. He's all by himself. Here comes the blitz. Over the middle of the field. Once again, finds the big tight end. Drops there. Steps away. Spin. Pop Thomas throws. The big left touchdown for the Hornets.
47
yards. DeAndre McNeil spins away, but Pop Thomas throws the steal block for the touchdown.
And that's not even the key play on that. Watch the snap, Mark. Perfect snap. He sets his feet and throws, stepping into it. There's no one there. The offensive line picks up their block. There's the play as he spins out of it. Somebody that big is not supposed to be that fleet of foot, and then fakes him out there, and then you get that Pop Thomas block, free him up for six.
McNeil, as Aguilar puts the foot into it, the kick is up.
Aguilar's extra point is good.
And the kick is good. With 5:10 to go, and we're still in the first quarter. It's the Hornets 21, Grossmont 6.
Aguilar now 33 of 33 extra point attempts this season.
Corey, you look at McNeil, big. He looks like a huge tight end, but he's a wide receiver for this Hornet team. And once he got hit, they weren't going to bring him. You look at it here.
Fourth touchdown from a different angle. And you can't be that wide open without a busted coverage. And the tackling, we were talking to the defensive coordinator for Grossmont. He said, we're a decent tackling team. We always want to be better. So far this season, we've been all right. So far this game, well, Fullerton's up 21-6 already.
Clueless and Brown back deep. And tempers have settled, and a football game is on right now. And I give both coaching staffs a great deal of credit for getting their players back into the game. Clueless looks at it. He takes it at the 10. Clueless tries to hit the middle. Finds a gap on the outside. Gets taken out of bounds by one of his own players right at the 30-yard line. 5:03 to go here in the first quarter. It's the Hornets 21, the Griffins 6. You're watching Fullerton College football on Sportsnet, USA.net, in conjunction with Fullerton College TV. Love this TV department. Ladies and gentlemen, you do an exquisite job running the cameras and giving us the shots. You make this game just special for everybody at home. Moyer brings his team out. First down and 10 at the 30. Moyer, quick, throws it into the pass, gives it to Tolbert. Tolbert turning the corner, stays on his feet, gets a gain of about 6 on the play.
You know, Mark, the most touchdowns in a season thrown by a Fullerton quarterback is 26. With the two today, Jordan Hoy has 19 through halfway through the season.
Second down and 4. He's close. He's close. Moyer, the backup quarterback in there.
Yeah, Darius Banks and Jose Escobar share that 26 total.
Moyer, shotgun formation. Second down and 4. Looks over to the sideline. Tolbert out wide to the right. Jones covering him one-on-one. Moyer sees it. See if he goes this direction. He was going to, and it was just going to be one-on-one. And it looked like he was going to go to Tolbert on that play because it was single-man coverage against him.
Yeah, and that's Dwayne Wood on the coverage. Again, Wood comes in out of Florida. He's had a solid season thus far. Saw time sparingly last season. This season, getting a lot of time as Jovan Burris comes in for Deshaun Taylor.
Brings up a third down and 4 right at the 36. Moyer brings him out. Tolbert comes out wide to the right. In the slot is going to be Javon Walker on the right-hand side. Third down and 4. The Hornets creep up. Last time it was a screen pass. Walker goes in motion. Now Walker stops. The Hornets come. They bring the blitz. Throw it over here. Incomplete pass. And once again, Corey, they're trying to confuse people as Alfalo goes out trying to catch the pass.
This time they just run a straight stunt with Justin Parcells coming up, Tyler Stepney coming out. He doesn't have enough time to set his feet to make a good throw.
So Alfalo can't come back and get it, and that brings Asante Wilder back deep for the Hornets.
Yeah, Tracy Thacker likes Asante Wilder. Thinks he's going to return one for a touchdown soon.
Wilder will stand at his own 25. 4:21 to go.
Fourth quarter?
Feels like it, doesn't it? I tell you, with the action, here comes big rush again. Wilder's going to take it. Right in his hand, back steps, looks for a wall. Jump steps, cuts, runs back in, turns in a circle, spins around like a clown on a top, and goes down at the 25.
Wilder on the return.
And we get, and guys, again, a flag out at the 40.
And good coverage by the Griffin special teams. It looks like he had room to run, but again, they fill their lanes, stay in their lanes, and never give up on the play. And Wilder, like you said, just spinning round and round, has nowhere to go.
And Brian Crooks went on the field and got Robert Johnson, who looks like that's the flag was thrown again, and basically took the young man, walked him quietly to the sideline and said, hey, let's not have any more flags.
Are you sure he walked him quietly to the sideline, Mark?
So it's going to be against Grossmont is going to be the penalty. They called in.
So there's the punt.
And Asante Wilder, as you see him, goes to his left, stops, a little jump cut there, tries to go back, goes back in the defender that almost had him, spins away from him, and when he does,
41.
He runs and gets caught from 10. Behind by another one.
You know what Asante's thinking? Why don't I just call a fair catch?
That's it. So with the unsportsmanlike conduct called against the Griffins, they move the ball all the way to the 40. 4:09 to go here in the first quarter. Game starts late because the referees are late. And boy, this first quarter is taking a while to get over. Hand it off to Pop Thomas. Pop Thomas says, I'll just go straight at him, Corey Neyland, and pick up 9 big yards.
So Pop Thomas, Phillip Butler. You're going to see Gerald Hewlett as well. Right up the middle. Positive gain of 7 yards.
Shotgun formation for Jordan Hornell. Pop Thomas goes off to the right. McNeil out wide to the left. Jordan Hoy keeps it himself. Goes up the middle. It's going to be short by about a foot. It's going to bring up third down and less than a yard for the Hornets.
Yeah, in 2013, Ryan Bird ran for 230 yards against Grossmont at Grossmont. And here's Hoy who keeps it. And it's all the quarterback's read. That's why they call it that read option.
Atkins out wide to the left. Atkins looks over the sideline. They reset, so Atkins out wide to the left. Simpson in the slot on the left-hand side. Jordan Hoy resets thing. Atkins at wide receiver, bump and run. They give it up to Pop Thomas. Pop just says, hand it off to me, I'll be the bulldozer, and gets the first down.
And Ryden Kerr was there to stop him after he picked up that first down, but a good job by the offensive line of creating that movement. That offensive line, as the season's going on, is getting a little bit more confident in their run package.
Atkins again out wide to the left. In the slot on the left-hand side is going to be Simpson. Jordan Hoy goes back, fakes it this time. There comes the blitz. Gets away from one. Strives to get away from another. The flag comes out, not the ball, but it gets taken down for a sack.
Good downfield coverage by the secondary. Only 3 people on route. 6 defenders, not going to complete a pass that way.
Loss of 6 on the play. It'll bring up a second down and 16 at the 47. Markell Atkins again out wide to left. Simpson in the slot on the left-hand side. Second down and 16. Jordan Hoy in a shotgun formation. Hoy tries to keep it himself. Hoy turns the corner, gets knocked out of bounds at the first stick. It's going to bring up a third down and a long 9 for the Hornets. So they're going to mark him out of bounds right at the 45. Hewlett now comes back in the game. Jerome Gross comes in here on the left-hand side. Grossman in the slot on the left-hand side. Inside Grossman is Asante Wilder. Third down and 9 right at the 45. Hewlett at a running back. Jordan Hoy in a shotgun formation. Big third down and 9 for the Hornets with a minute 40 to go. Hoy goes back the other direction. Tries to throw there. Spin away by McNeil. Tries to stay on his feet. Gets across the 40 down to the 38. Okay, coach, I'm putting you on the spot.
Go for it. Yeah, you're going to go for it. I mean, your offense is running. You're pretty well. Your defense is playing excellent. Yeah, I think I'm going to go for it. You have the option. Gerald Hewlett, if he breaks into that second level, Grossmont's going to have problems. But Grossmont's done a nice job when they've had 4 defensive linemen up front of getting good push on the Hornets, though.
Fourth down and a long 1. Hewlett in the backfield. Jordan Hoy tries to get him the jump. Gross in the slot. Grossman. Gross out wide to left. Grossman in the slot on the left-hand side. McNeil out wide to the right. Hewlett in the backfield. Jordan Hoy's got time, pitches and catches. Throws right there on the money. Nice little catch taken out of the air by Asante Wilder, and Wilder just found the soft spot and gets a first down.
If you have a replay, you love this. Here's the replay. Fourth down and one, and they roll out. Hoy wasn't thinking about running. He could have run and crawled across the field to pick up the first down. Instead, he's looking for Wilder wide open for the first down.
They throw to Hewlett, coming out of the backfield on a first down and 10. Hewlett catches it, turns the corner, steps out of bounds. After he crosses over the 20, they're going to mark him out at the 18.
And forced out by Luckman Barku.
30 seconds to go in the marathon first quarter here on SportsnetUSA.net. Corey Neyland, I'm Mark Pavlovich. Ryan Osborne down on the field. And the Hornets knocking on the door once again with the clock ticking. Jordan Hoy looks over the defense. Second down and 7. Griffins want to bring a blitz. Hewlett takes it on the middle, follows that offensive line, cuts to the outside, loses the football. It goes into the end zone. They try to run it out, and Corey, their Grossmont's going to take it out. And Hewlett loses it in the end zone. And Grossmont dodges the bullet at the end of the first quarter.
Right before he crosses the goal line, ball pops loose. I mean, Jordan Hewlett, he got to the second level. Like we said, there was going to be problems. But the problem was he coughed it up.
You see Hewlett gets a great block, plants his foot, gives a straight arm, and then a little punch out of a football. And then the decision to run it out by Grossmont, should have taken a knee in the end zone. Once again, you watch Hewlett. Gets a great block by his offensive line.
Muhammad Jefferson there.
Nice straight arm, and then gets it punched out. And Corey, they retreat. I thought for a second, possible safety. Gets out of the end zone. As we come to the end of the first quarter, it's the Hornets 21, the Griffins 6. You're watching Fullerton College Football on Sportsnet, USA.net. Two turnovers, big turnovers now for the Hornets in this game. Boy, I tell you what I need now is a large cup of coffee and a dozen donuts from one of the sweetest donut shops in the area, Dunkin' Donuts. I tell you what, guys, put the call out. I'll take some of those Bavarian creams, and I'll get ready for that big old box of Dunkin' Donuts here on SportsnetUSA.net. That's right. I got to watch myself. Getting excited up here in the booth.
Mark needs a sling.
So the Griffins looking to do something. Moyer now looks at Spradley, moves him from left to right. Fulton in the backfield. Moyer throws over the middle screen, and it is just thought out. And talking about people that thinks out defenses, Ron Osborne, you down there in the field to tell me a little about this team?
I can actually tell you a little bit about that melee that ensued earlier. Tyler Stepney hit Kiegler, both of their helmets popped out. Grossmont wanted a taunting penalty on Stepney, and they also wanted a penalty on Quentin Yontz for standing on top of Kiegler while he was down. That's what started the melee, and the offensive line of Grossmont took offense. Back to you guys.
Thank you. Second down and 10. Cleavis comes out wide to left. Tolbert comes out wide to the right. Moyer comes back. They're looking for Cleavis down the side. Up. Is he in? They're going to mark him as a catch at the 35-yard line.
It was a phenomenal catch, and it looks like he got one of those feet down. So Cluis.
Cluis is what they're calling him. So Cluis comes down. So I apologize, it's Cluis. Cluis comes out wide to the right.
I don't think he got that foot down. He may have got the right foot down, but I didn't see it.
Moyer goes back again, looks over. Here comes a pressure, middle of the field, just thrown. And just throwing it, nobody was on the right page on that one, Corey, as Michael Ledsema wasn't even looking for the ball.
Yeah, but the catch was so nice. I think I'd give him to it anyway.
You give it to Cluis?
Yeah, might as well.
Okay.
You got new linebackers, Xavier Chisholm and Jamal Scott, the normal starters for Fullerton, are in there with Justin Parcells. Secondary is Taj Jones on the near side. Far side is Tim Gordon. Safeties, near side is Javon Burris. Number 4 on the far side is Dwayne Wood for you.
Cluis comes out wide left. Spradley now goes from left to right. Fulton in the backfield. Moyer looks over. Tolbert out wide to the right. A little confusion by the Griffins. So we get timeout with 14:31 to go here in the second quarter. It's the Hornets 21, the Griffins 6. You're watching Fullerton College Football on SportsnetUSA.net in conjunction with Fullerton College TV.
Well, he saw, Moyer saw Marcus Lewis, Nick Della Rocca, Montre Bronner, all up front, and saw him coming, so he decided, you know what, let me take a moment, compose myself, and come back. Maybe I want to get something to eat.
Well, that's what I was going to do, because I was going to say, with the timeout in the field, we ought to all run out and get maybe a slice of pepperoni pizza or anchovy pizza or maybe just regular cheese pizza from Pep's Pizza here on Yorba Linda Boulevard. Pep's Pizza, one of the sweetest pizza you can ever eat. And I tell you what, if you think, well, I need something more than that, well, Islands in Fullerton and Brea, gourmet hamburgers, gourmet wraps, and the best French fries you'll ever have. Islands, either in Brea or Fullerton. You want to take a little time out, watch a little football, eat a great hamburger, try Islands in Brea or Fullerton.
They don't have an
Don't forget Dunkin' Donuts, always with SportsnetUSA.net. We already talked about that big cup of coffee and those Bavarian creams, or maybe that glazed donut that's just sweet, like the offense from Fullerton, Dunkin' Donuts on Yorba Linda. Moyer goes back, throws over the middle of the field, tries to clue us, it gets tipped there, interception.
And that's Dwayne Wood, the tip against Spradling, and Taj Jones comes up. Both teams playing the tip drill today as Moyer tries to force it in.
And Jamal Scott gets his hands on it first, right, Corey? Wasn't it Jamal that played the first defense against Clueless, or am I wrong?
No, that was Dwayne Wood.
Okay, all right.
So Wood gets Taj Jones his first interception of the season, and for Wood, that is his first pass breakup of the season. And again, Moyer is throwing off of his back foot, Mark, so he doesn't have any zing on that ball. And again, it floats out there, and Wood, instead of waiting for the receiver to catch it, plays the ball, undercuts him, tips it away, and Jones is there for the pick.
Robert Johnson out wide to the left. Grossmont in the slot on left-hand side. I'm thinking, wait a minute, that's the opponents, Mark.
Well, you
what
could
you
get
about?
Confused. Grossmont, and Gross.
Jordan Hoy at quarterback. At least I got that right. And Pop Thomas says, just give it to me because I'm going to turn the corner. And Pop does, stays on his feet. They can't take him down. Pop's carrying the defense for Grossmont and refuses to go down after it gets across the 40.
Ryden Kurris, 5'11", 235 pounds. But the problem is, Kentavious Thomas is strong at 5'11", 210 out of Georgia. You come up and tackle him on the shoulders, he'll just put you on his back and carry you four more yards.
Nice block by Williams, the tight end on the left-hand side. It's going to be that second down and one.
And it's just a sweep play to the left side. He finds and waits for his blocking and then finds a hole to cut up. And again, see how high Kerr is up? You can't tackle anybody like that. So he's just riding him, trying to ride him down to the ground.
Little bobble, ball on the ground. Jordan Hoy picks it up, throws it to Hewlett, who throws down the middle. Ball's up in the air, fight for the ball, incomplete pass. So what the play was supposed to be was Jordan Hoy gets it, throws a backward pass to Hewlett, or technically a lateral because it's behind the quarterback. So this is a lateral, even though it's a pass. Hewlett has the option to run or throw. Hewlett throws it, incomplete pass.
The timing of the pass was cut off because he had Justin Walker on the far side, and if he has time, he can set his feet and look for both receivers.
Third down and one. Hand it up the middle. Taking it there. Hewlett needs to cut back inside. Hewlett does. Stays on his feet. First down for the Hornets.
Smart running by a running back. Instead of a speedy back trying to get to the outside, the pursuit was there for the Grossmont Griffins. He decides to cut it up, get the first down, and you move the chains.
13:24 to go here in the first half. It's the Hornets 21, the Griffins 6.
And Tristan Lopez did a nice job of tackling him around the waist, bringing him down to the ankles and to the ground. Vince a bigger game.
Walker comes out wide to the right. Asante Wilder in the slot on the right-hand side. Jordan Hoy goes back. Hewlett's back there. Throws it to Asante Wilder. And Asante Wilder was left in no man's land on that play.
That was just a waste play. You know when you got an 0-2 count on a ball, on a batter, pitcher has, you know I'm going to waste one? That was that play there.
Second down. And they're going to call it 12. Jerome Gross goes out wide to the left. Simpson in the slot on the left-hand side. Asante Wilder goes with him. Second down and 12. Jordan Hoy in the backfield. Empty backfield. Here comes the blitz. Jordan Hoy peeks it out himself. Stays on his feet. Dances. Holds on. And it's going to be a nice gain of 8 for Jordan Hoy, bringing up a third down and 4.
And this is what you want to be in. And a designed run.
And here comes the beef for the Hornets.
And look at the backfield, Mark.
Samuel Davis is now in the game with Isaiah Jackson under center. Hands it off to Pop Thomas. Pop Thomas can't get away from anybody. It's going to bring up a fourth down. Boy, this is one long field goal if they're going to try it.
No, I'd go for it again, and I'd run the same play because if Pop Thomas can pop that tackle off the off tackle, he's in the end zone for 6.
And, Corey, that was their jumbo offensive line they bring out there. Samuel Davis, 6'4", 360 pounds is the lead guard that was just out there.
Yeah, just better defense.
5 wide for the Hornets now. Jerome Gross goes out wide to the right. Simpson in the slot with Asante Wilder on the right-hand side. Grossman out wide to the left, and we're going to get timeout by Grossmont. So with 11:15 to go here in the first half, it's the Hornets 21, the Griffins 6. You're watching Fullerton College Football on Sportsnet, USA.net.
You see the timeout called because Grossmont, they know it's going to be a design run for Jordan Hoy. They split out 5 receivers, 3 on the left, right, 2 on the left. But the problem is the defense is waiting for that design run, so everybody's bunched up into the line of scrimmage. And the secondary only was covering 2 of the 3 receivers on the right side and only 1 on the left side, so you have to call that timeout to get yourselves organized.
So it's like me getting in my brand-new Toyota from Miller Toyota of Anaheim and pulling up next to Avery from the radio class and seeing him in that clunky old Datsun and just saying, hey, I'll meet you at the field in 5 minutes. Avery's going to get here at halftime. I'm going to pull in here 15 minutes before the game, driving that new Toyota from Miller Toyota of Anaheim. Poor Avery. Running late again. You ought to be an official for football. They don't get here on time. Jordan Hoy in the backfield.
Hear what Avery just said?
What?
What's a Datsun?
Pop Thomas in the backfield with Jordan Hoy. 4th down and 3. They try to get the Griffins to jump. Hoy looks over. McNeil out wide to the right. Simpson in the slot. Williams a tight end close on the left-hand side. Big 4th down. Jordan Hoy looks over the defense. The Griffins are going to come after him. Hoy takes it himself. Gets a block to the outside. High steps. 1st down. Corey, what a sealed block on the corner. Ball comes out. Hornets come up with it.
So they pick up 5 on the run, 4 more on the fumble.
Watch the seal on the corner here by that lead pulling tackle.
Marshall Levins gets the seal block. And the ball is brought down. It was a fumble. There you see it on the ground there. Fullerton just gets underneath and recovers. I think Hoy recovered his own fumble.
1st down and 10 at the 14-yard line. Neal out wide to the right. Simpson in the slot. Williams the tight end on the left. Jordan Hoy. Pop Thomas goes in motion. Hoy goes back. Looks in the middle of the field. Touchdown, Hornets! There's that tight end number 2 for the day.
Christian Williams open on a quick little look in as Grossmont brought the blitz. You see him here. They bring the backers and Williams, they leave Williams wide open for an easy 6 points. And that's his 3rd touchdown of the season. Jordan Hoy's 20th.
10:42 to go. And I'm sure the Saddleback scouts who are here at today's game are just saying, how many notes can I take and what don't they run?
Well, that's the head coach of Saddleback was over there.
Aguilar puts it through the upright. He stays perfect for the season.
34-34.
Grossmont 6. So with 10:42 to go here at homecoming. That's right, the 100th homecoming. Mickey Flynn was here for number 1. I was here for number 2. Gene Murphy was here for number 3. Phil Thurman's been here for 11. Yeah, Phil's a youngster, isn't he? He's only been here for 11 homecomings. You know, I won't tell your wife, though, you bring a different date to every homecoming game. I won't do that. And she'll never know for me.
And you know, Mark, 34-34, that's not bad. But when you look across the rich tradition of Fullerton College football, 34-34, you got a long way to go to match the record of 53 in a season, and 53-53 by Sam Pelescu.
I was just going to say, it's got to be Sammy from the old days. That used to be my man, Sammy Pelescu. He kicked a field goal at Santa Monica, Corey, that was 2 feet off the ground when it took off. We never thought it was going to get there. Sammy got it through the upright cell. Played for the Dallas Cowboys. Sammy Pelescu, an alumni of Fullerton College. Deep kick, deep in the end zone. Going to take a knee right there.
You mean that 53-yarder at Santa Monica?
That is that what it was?
That was 2 yards short from the record?
Yeah. Sammy was something sweet. And, of course, we talk about alumni. Well, don't forget, people like James Cameron and Pat Nixon went to Fullerton College. People like Bob Jensen, head of the Fine Arts Division, and my theater buddies, Michael Moynihan and Ronnie Dickinson, some of the people that were over at Fullerton College for a lot of years. Clueless comes out wide to the left. Moyer's got to find some offense eventually. Moyer's going to hand it to the backfield. Brown's got no place to go as he looks like a biscuit with gravy on top as he gets smothered by the defense. So Brown, it's going to be a loss of 2 on the play. 10:29 to go. Don't forget, after this game tonight, Golden West College takes on Saddleback here on Sportsnet USA. .net.
Don't we have some high school football today?
Eight-man football on SportsnetUSA.net. Clueless comes out wide left, straddling in the slot on the left-hand side. Moyer changing the play at the line of scrimmage. Javon Walker, tight. They go over here, go to throw to Spradling. Sidesteps, one gets taken down, no gain on the play.
And you know, Mark, that's only no, you said no gain. 143 yards passing for the opponents of Fullerton College. That's best in the state through the first 5 games.
Third down and 12. Well, the game started off shaky. It looked like the Hornets were in a dogfight. There were fist fights on the field and arguments.
You said, what has Fullerton done? They haven't had an adversarial game thus far. It started out like that, but then as soon as it started, it ended because they had 2 straight drives to really take control of this first half.
And the best way to shut up an opponent, put points on the board. Clueless out to the white. Tolbert out white to the left. They throw it out into the flat, taken there by Brown. Brown trying to stay on his feet. He could not get the first down. And so if you're the Griffins, you're going to have to punt it away. 9:08 to go. Stick around with us at halftime. We're going to let you know what the Hornets did here at halftime with stats. And I don't know, maybe Ryan Osborne will find somebody to talk to during the halftime here on SportsNetUSA.net.
Let me rephrase that.
Ryan Osborne will find somebody to talk to, right?
Better have somebody to talk to at halftime. That's more like it.
And Ryan, we know you can hear us down there, so, you know.
And he puts a thumbs up and he says, okay, I got you.
All right, Ryan Osborne at halftime. Stick around with us.
Because if not, Gabrielle is going to have to come on the air and we're just going to shoot the breeze.
There we go. Darius Simpson is back deep for the Hornets. Get timeout by the Hornets. So with 8:38 to go here in the first half, it's the Hornets 28, Grossmont 6. You're watching Fullerton College TV. You're watching Fullerton College football on SportsnetUSA.net in conjunction with Fullerton College TV. Boy, guys, I just wanted to give you so much love. If you are looking to be involved in entertainment, if you want to be that person, well, you don't like being in front of the camera, but you want to be involved, you want to learn what it takes to put on a fantastic production like the TV crew does for every football game out here at Chappelle Stadium, you know what? Enroll over at Fullerton College. What a great television and film program they have over there. Some of the best instructors in the nation. You'll learn more than anybody else, and by the time you leave, you'll be ready to work in the industry. Fullerton College TV, sign up for it. If you want to do it, come and join them. The only way to learn is to be out here with us on SportsnetUSA.net. Darius Simpson, back deep. Simpson comes up, takes it at the 32, looking for the wall. Gets one wall with a nail in it, and we get a flag on. I'm going to refer to my partner There's a flag, and I've got to ask you why.
The only way they can call this flag on Jamal Scott if they say he came up with his forearm into the face of the Grossmont tackler defender. That's the only way you can call a penalty on that particular block.
And we're going to get that on replay.
So I don't know if there was another flag down at the 40.
No replay, so we don't get it on replay right now. And, Corey, I'd love to see I really would, because I thought it was a clean block.
Well, it looked like a clean block. Jamal Scott made an effort to get in front of the defender chasing down Darius Simpson and put on the block. The only thing they can say is if they saw that chicken wing come up and out up to the face of the defender. So otherwise, Simpson, you're going to have to pick it up.
Simpson got taken out at the 40-yard line, so the ball is spotted there. The Grossmont coaches, who are all right, so we're all shaking their heads.
So here's the replay.
And they picked up the flag.
So they got it right here. And, yeah, no, that was just a clean block.
So Simpson gets run out of bounds at the 40-yard line. The flag is picked up on what looked like a clean block. And after discussion, and you like that by officials, everybody discusses it and tries to get it right. It'll be first down and 10 for the Hornets at the 40. 28-6. 8:26 to go here in the first half. Very contentious first quarter. If you're just tuning in with us, a lot of people grabbing, a lot of arguments on the field, a lot of people not really happy with what their players were doing.
Sounds like Thanksgiving, don't it?
Yeah, it was a sluggish. Yeah, and everybody seemed like they ate too much turkey. They were moving so slow. Ty Gibson out wide to the left for the Hornets. Jordan Hoy under center, split back set. Hoy hands it off to Hewlett. Hewlett sees the gap, turns the corner, gets a gain of three on the play.
Good blocking, better defense by Dominic Juarez Lewis. Lewis out of University City High School, San Diego, 5'11", 200 pounds, a sophomore, and good tackle on Hewlett.
So we've got holding against the Hornets. That's going to bring it back.
Hold is going to be on Marshall Levins. He was a lead blocker out there, Mark, and he just had a fistful of jersey.
So McNeil comes back in the game. Grossman comes back in the game. Asante Wilder back in the game. So Jerome Gross out wide to the right. Asante Wilder next to him. Grossman in the slot on the right-hand side. McNeil out wide to the left. First down and 20 for the Hornets. They hand it off to Hewlett. Hewlett goes straight off the left guard and gets a gain of maybe a half a yard.
And that's the way you feel, right? And Kerr, we've been calling his name a lot in the first half. Comes up to make the stop.
So second down for the Hornets, right at the 49. Hoy goes into a shotgun formation. Hoy rolls away from the pressure. Here comes the pressure. Finds Asante Wilder and just overshoots Asante Wilder, who had good double coverage on him.
Yeah, and that was a zone defense employed by the Griffins, and a good. They had one man deep, one man up. That zone was too tight to fit the ball through.
Third down and 19, right at the 49-yard line. So third down. McNeil out wide to left. Out wide to the right is going to be Gross. Asante Wilder in the slot on the right-hand side. Grossman, closest one in the slot on the right. Jordan Hoy, shotgun formation. Hewlett, the running back. Big third down and 19 for the Hornets, right at the 49. Hoy goes back, has time to throw, steps up, steps away, still has time to throw. Wants to recock, couldn't. Good coverage, perfect pressure. And the Hornets are going to have to punt it away.
Best defensive stand that time by the Griffins we've seen today.
So that's going to bring in Austin McGahee coming in. McGahee averages almost 40 yards a punt for the Hornets. He's right at 39.9 right now. Back deep is going to be James Julius for the Griffins. Julius is going to stand at the 10. McGahee has time, no pressure. High floater. Julius is going to signal for a fair catch. Lets it bounce. It goes into the end zone. Nice play by Julius. who nonchalantly put his arm up and let it bounce in the end zone for a touchback.
Well, if I'm McGahee, I'm a little bit worried about my special teams unit, because that's one where they have to get behind the ball before that comes down so they can knock it down after three. Better play by the receiving team. McGahee out of Pine Bluff, Arkansas. Everybody in Pine Bluff, hello. We know you got the big screen out there and watching this game instead of anything else down there in SEC country.
First down and 10 at the 20. The Hornets are up by 22. Clewis comes out wide to left. Tolbert goes out wide to the right. Fulton in the backfield. Moyer at quarterback. First down and 10. Moyer goes back. Quick step. Looking for Tolbert down there. D'Angelo Ross is with him. Ball hits the ground, not caught. And Clewis says, no, I tried to get it. And D'Angelo Ross, doesn't matter how big they are, he covers them.
No, that's what we like about D'Angelo Ross. I mean, D'Angelo is not afraid to cover anybody. He wants to be one-on-one against the other team's best wide receiver. That's what we like about the Husky from South Hills. You see the replay here, Mark, and there was just good defensive coverage.
Smith goes out wide to the right. Clewis comes out wide left. Moyer goes in a shotgun formation. Second down and 10. Here he comes, and he is just eaten up and swallowed like a Twinkie.
Dominic Sanchez, we saw him. He ate a couple Twinkies in his lifetime. Another one right here. You see the replay. Xavier Chisholm, who's coming back, trying to get healthy for the rest of the way. He's the first man through. And Sanchez just, well, like you said, ate.
Another sack by the Hornet defense. They don't get talked about.
Well, that's Dominic's first. But, again, we talked to Brian Crooks before the game. And it's before the season, he said, I'm a little worried about my defensive line. Well, not anymore.
Feeling better. Clewis out wide to the left. Tolbert out wide to the right. Moyer trying to throw it over in the flat. Fulton gets grabbed, but no flag coming down the backfield. That's going to bring up a fourth down.
Yeah, this defensive line has been surprising this season. He talked about the 2013 team. Defensive ends, he said, might be better this year. Defensive interior, defensive tackles, more athletic in 2013. That was with Corey Gabriel on that defensive unit. I have to agree with that assessment.
Simpson goes back deep for the Hornets. 6 minutes to go in the first half. It's the Hornets, 28, the Griffins, 6. So the Hornets trying to stay undefeated. First conference game, want to be 6-0. High snap, take it out there. They get a hand on it. Blocked at the 10. The Hornets get the ball picked up. They're turning the corner. Touchdown, Fullerton College.
And that's Robert Johnson. They're going to say he stepped out of bounds at the 11 when he picked it up. So no touchdown. And it's either Deshaun Taylor, if we have the replay, or it's either Deshaun Taylor or Lane Taylor who came up and blocked that. Reminiscent. I'm going to take you back to Al Guidry. Those days back in there. Kirk Compton back in the early 90s there.
Al Guidry is still running home for Bakersfield. He's still waiting for me to pick him up. So you said special teams needed to stand up and do something special. And Corey, you talked about it last time up. Special teams really need to do something. McGahee's ball goes in the end zone and you said, special teams needs to do something. They come up with a big block as Jordan Hoy looks over the sideline trying to get the play. And now Jordan Hoy sort of signals in. He's getting the play left. He flips lop his receivers. McNeil now goes wide to the left. Jerome Gross comes out wide to the right with Asante Wilder and Grossman on the right-hand side. They look for McNeil. Nothing's there. Go back to Grossman. Grossman catches it, tucks his head, almost gets in the end zone. Beautiful block by Hewlett. As we have a player down on the ground, we'll see if he gets up. He does.
James Julius
gets
up
quickly.
And on the replay, you see Grossman here makes the good catch and makes that cut, just tripped up by Julius.
Hewlett in the backfield. They hand it off to Hewlett. Puts everybody in his back. Touchdown by the Hornets.
Hewlett takes the ball in for another 14 score.
Number 3 for the year. So the Hornets get on the board again, and that 60-point marker is starting to look like it's looming large here for the Hornets. 5:32 to go here in the first half. the Hornets once again are dominant on defense and offense. Aguilar comes in. It's been perfect this season. Ball is spotted, kick is up. And the kick is good. With 5:32 to go, it's now the Hornets 35, the Griffins 6. You are watching Fullerton College Football on Sportsnet, USA.net, in conjunction with Fullerton College TV. And you've got to look at what's going on here for Hornet fans at home. Well, next week we'll be on the road. Corey Neyland and I will be at Saddleback. Saddleback plays Golden West tonight in their first conference game. Saddleback is currently 5-0. The Hornets coming into this game were currently 5-0. For anybody watching right now, the journey looks like you need to be undefeated in the Southern section to get to the playoffs. Let's not look too far ahead. We have another half of football, but Grossmont was the first challenge. Next week, it'll be audio on sportsnetusa.net, so make sure you stick around for the rest of the season. Any hiccup along the way, and the dreams are crushed. Aguilar comes in. Big, booming kick. Lots of foot one more time, and it's going to be with a knee down.
And, Mark, you know what I forgot to do?
What's that?
I forgot to tell everybody. Give us a tweet. Tell us how you're enjoying this game in the first half. At Sportsnet USA, which is Mark. At Sportsnet USA Net, which is me. Go ahead and tweet out that you're watching Fullerton College Football on SportsnetUSA.net in conjunction with Fullerton College TV.
Clues comes out wide left. Guys, in the slot on the left-hand side. Moyer goes back, looks the other direction, tries to get it to Tolbert, can't as it gets knocked down at the line of scrimmage. Second down and 10 for the Griffins.
Mitchell Hurtado with the deflection. And coming up at halftime to read the stats, David Garcia is going to read the stats for us. We're going to have an interview. Ryan Osborne's going to have someone down on the field for us.
There's Ryan over in the corner. Ryan gives his little thumb up. Ryan's going to be doing eight-man football later on tonight on SportsNetUSA.net.
Second hardest working man at Fullerton.
That's it. Moyer bobbles it, throws it up, almost. And Corey Clues thought he had a catch, and the Hornets thought they had a pick on a bobbled snap. Third down and 10 at the 25. So the Hornets looking good, and once again, you look at who has been here, an alumnus out here. You know, you look, this is homecoming. Think of some of the people that have gone. Tim Buckley, an alumnus at Fullerton. James Cameron, William Conrad, Bob Kramer. Alumnus, it's homecoming day here at Fullerton. Third down and 10, Moyer goes back. Here comes the pressure, has time to throw. Middle of the field, throws it behind Tolbert, incomplete pass. And the backup quarterback has not been able to sustain any offense for the Griffins.
Well, he hasn't been able to get comfortable in the pocket. When you're uncomfortable in these situations, you can't step into your throws. You can't get any rhythm with your receivers. And it just creates for a long afternoon.
Simpson back deep again. He's going to stand at his 35. Last time the Hornets came out and blocked the punt. Big turnover. They got everybody talking to each other on the line of scrimmage. They're going to come from the corner. Simpson looks over at the sideline. Here they come. Once again, up the middle. Try to get there in time. Don't. Simpson's going to let it hit. It does. He picks it up in the bounce and turns the corner. Sidesteps. Puts on the gas. Cuts back in the middle. Goes across the middle of the field. It's going to be a flag against the Hornets as they turn the corner. Simpson at the 40. Gives another little foot, takes it away, out of bounds at the 28, but that one's coming back to the 49.
As it should. I mean, you see the kick, they almost get it there, and Simpson thought about letting it go, but as he picks it up on the run, and again, he gets there to the sideline and reverses the field. So he runs 20 yards up the field, 50 yards across the field, 10 yards up. I'm out of breath just looking at it.
Well, so you go 50 yards up the field, 10 yards up, turnaround, half and a back. Ryan Osborne, this math problem's for you. Divide it by two. Take the total score. Take 15% of that. Put it underneath. Give me the medium fraction of what's going on in the first half when we go back down on the field. Oh, he gave us the figure two. So I guess that's the answer is two. Well, Ryan's made it through math already. Future student over at Cal State Fullerton. We know all the Cal State Fullerton people know math.
Not in the booth.
Jordan Hoy back in a shotgun formation. Feels the pressure. Hoy's got time to throw Corey. He stands there, looks at everybody, takes off running, says, throw me a block. Doesn't get a block, but gets up to the 45. The offensive line is giving him 5 seconds to throw the football.
Yeah, Luckman Barku tripped him up. And again, he was looking for a post pattern up the over the middle to Darius Simpson. Good safety work. You can't let anybody get behind you. Here's the replay. He just tucks it down and takes off. He is faster than you think when you get up close.
Or he rolls against the traffic. Leaning over Robert Johnson. Throws it over the middle field. Throws it to McNeil. McNeil, the underneath receiver, makes the catch and goes out of bounds at the 30.
And that's a good job by the offensive line, the quarterback, and the receiver, all doing their jobs for the appropriate amount of time as he waited for the receivers to get through their route, and he reached his progression to a second option.
Atkins comes out wide to the right. McNeil goes out in the slot on the left. First down and 10. They hand it up the middle. Pop Thomas trying to get away, just can't. Finally, they're going to call him down after a gain of one on the play.
Quantarius Boone.
Pop Thomas, carrier, brought down by.
So they bring in Asante Wilder, is going to come into the game. Also with Justin Walker as they change out the receivers. William, the big tight end, who's got two touchdowns today, back in the game. Walker goes out wide to left. Asante Wilder in the slot. Left-hand side. Watch your tight end on the right-hand side. They fake it. Jordan Hoy feels the pressure. Going deep. Flat in the corner. Can you flat it out? Flag on the play as he was getting pushed out of the end zone. And, Corey, you eat that flag if you're an official.
I don't like that flag. You just
eat the flag.
Good, solid defense. Here's your replay. Walker had no chance. The ball was overthrown anyway, out of bounds. Craig Butcher had perfect position on Walker, and you still throw that flag just because there was a little contact. Nah.
So the Hornets get the benefit of the doubt by the official. That's going to give them an automatic first down with 3 minutes and 40 seconds to go. Here in the first half, the Hornets are up by 29. It's the Hornets 35, the Griffins 6. So all of a sudden now the Hornets bring in Johnny Carmack at quarterback. Carmack in at quarterback. Keeps it himself. Carmack stays on his feet. Gets across the 10. So Carmack, the freshman out of Santa Clara, now in at quarterback for the Hornets.
And he does a good job of running when he's in there. I mean, he creates another good running back behind the center, and he's going to come out for Hoy.
So they bring out the entire squad that was with Carmack, bring Hoy back in, Hewlett comes back in, Anthony Wood now in, so it's Hewlett and Anthony Wood, it's the split backs in the backfield, Santi Wilder out wide to the left in the slot, Simpson outside of him on the left-hand side, Williams the tight end on the right-hand side. They run a pitch play, throw it to Hewlett, Hewlett's got a block, gets hit right there. Nice defense by the Griffins. That looked like that was an easy touchdown.
Yeah, it did. But again, they converged three of them on that left side. Asante Wilder can only block one. But Curtis Brooks and Dominic Juarez Luis, two of the three on the tackle.
Get timeout by the officials. So it's an official timeout at the field with third down and one. They're going to measure third down and one.
No need.
So we're sitting at 2 minutes and 28 seconds. It's the Hornets, 35. The Griffins, 6. You are watching Fullerton College football on Sportsnet, USA.net, in conjunction with Fullerton College TV. Corey Neyland, Mark Pavlovich, Ryan Osborne down on the field. Ready to tell us a tale or two. So it's going to be third down.
Third down is one.
And a very skinny one down on the field. Crowd's rather quiet. Hornets looking to go 6-0. Feeling good. Halloween around the corner. Jordan Hoy takes it himself. Jordan Hoy in, touchdown, Fullerton College.
Hoy in for the score.
So Jordan Hoy fakes the handoff, goes up the middle, unscathed into the end zone. So we're looking at records to see points. We get a flag on the field. Record book is being looked at.
We think so, Phil. We think so.
So my historians are looking at the record book right now at 2 minutes and 16 seconds.
So most points in a quarter, 35.
35 and a quarter, right?
Yeah. Oh, 49.
So most points in a quarter, they tied with 35. Most points in a half is 49.
Most points in a game, 79. 2013 versus Grossmont. Most points in a half, 2013 versus Orange Coast. Most points in a quarter, 35 if they make this field goal twice against Grossmont. 2013, now 2016.
You know, we know Aguilar is perfect, but Johnny Carmack is the holder for the kicker. And even though your kicker is perfect, let's give Carmack a lot of credit. You bobble it when the ball is spotted and the kick is up and the kick is good. We all talk about the kicker, but you got to give him a lot of love to that holder, Johnny Carmack, the holder on all these field goals. And how many is that in a row now?
35.
35 extra points where there has not been one bobble by Johnny Carmack, one of the backup quarterbacks here for the Hornets on Sportsnet USA. .net. Well, I tell you what, if you're a Hornet fan right now, you could get that new Toyota from Miller Toyota of Anaheim. Go down to Dunkin' Donuts, buy a dozen
36.
Donuts. 36? Buy 36 donuts at Dunkin' Donuts? That's what we're doing? That's what Corey wants to do. He wants to get those Bavarian creams.
Every consecutive extra point made, yeah.
36 okay, we donuts, want a donut 36 for extra points made. Extra point, and then later on today, we're going to go over to Islands. Have a couple burgers, and then late tonight, I'm stopping at Pep's Pizza because I'm getting ready for football tomorrow. I'm going to get me that extra large with extra cheese, oops, and extra anchovies from Pep's Pizza. Want to thank all our sponsors for making all these games possible on SportsnetUSA.net. Oh, I look good driving that new Toyota. I don't know about them 36 donuts. I'll eat one, and I'll give you 35 of them. Now, you'll eat one, I'll eat one, and Ron Osborne can have 34. He can have four. His imaginary brother can have 30. How's that? Hornets get flagged on the extra point, so gets that marked off. Off the side of the foot, taken there by Clueless. Clueless at the 20, sort of stutter steps, tries to get to the 35 and just can't make it.
Clueless on the return.
So we're at the 2 minute and 11 second mark here in the first half. On the kickoff. So it's a little slider kickoff. Clueless takes it at the 20, ducks inside at the 30, stutter steps, and then gets met by a horde of Hornets right there.
Led by Deshaun Taylor. So Jamal Scott, Xavier Chisholm, two of the linebackers, the middle linebacker, the mic person is Cody Darrow. Daniel Robinson. Derek Fletcher in his two secondary units.
Moyer goes back, looking to go deep. Tries there, almost caught. Flag on the play. Tolbert was there. They're calling pass interference against the Hornets. Tell me, there's a replay.
Jeremy Lacy, excellent coverage, stride for stride. And it was right to him. Tolbert did a nice job of being the defender and breaking up the play. But the pass interference, if there's any, should have been on Grossmont.
Wow. Okay, I thought I'd let you describe it because, you know, I'm old. I figured I didn't see it right. First down and 10. Moyer goes back. trying to get it. He's going to go the same direction. It's step for step again. That one is knocked out of bounds against Tolbert at the last second. Incomplete pass.
And it wouldn't have counted anyway because the receiver stepped out of bounds.
Second down and 10.
Wow.
So, yeah, that first one, it was. Out wide left is going to be Vincent. Now he backs up just a little. Vincent steps up back of the line of scrimmage. In motion goes Geis. They're going to hand it off right there. Fulton stutter steps. Gets a gain of about 2 on the play. It's going to bring up a third down and a long 6 yards for the Griffins right at the 48.
And there is Cody Darrell and Quentin, not Quentin Yance. Hosby is in there, Jose Bermejo.
Third down. Bissant comes out wide to the left in the slot. Next to him, left-hand side is Letzema. Michael Letzema in the game now. Warrior under center. Third down. Goes back, steps back, tries to throw it over, does. Bobble then caught by Litzema, taken down. He's short of a first down.
Brought down by Fletcher.
And you see him bobble the ball with good concentration.
Down and 1 yard to go.
He brings up a manageable fourth down. I believe Grossmont is 0 for 3 on fourth downs in this first half.
They hand it off, and it's going to be enough. And this time, the Griffins get that first down right at the 40-yard line.
But this one was a manageable. The first three were 6 yards or more. This one, fourth and one, and they find that opening and pick it up.
So we're under a minute here in the first half. It's the Hornets, 42, the Griffins, 6.
And, Mark, if you're just joining in, no, the game didn't start at 1 o'clock, and this was just a long first half. Game started hour, and it's still a long first half.
Clueless. Runs a slant pattern right on the money and gets taken down. We have a flag behind the play with 37 seconds to go.
And you wonder what the flag is going to be. Illegal shift?
Or a pick?
Yeah, you know it's not a false start because you call a pick?
Ineligible receiver downfield. I need to see who went downfield.
You got your receivers, you got...
Your offensive line stays at home. Your receivers are the only ones that go downfield. And you throw a flag?
Well, the tight end came out.
Yeah, but the tight end wasn't covered. So if the tight end's not covered, he gets to come out downfield.
Got none for you.
All right. Moyer goes back, throws it deep, looking to go to Tolbert. Tolbert said, I was grabbed and held. There's no flag on the play with 25 seconds to go.
Now that time, there should have been a flag on the play. As you see the replay, Tolbert en route. You see the jersey.
A little stretch there.
Well, jersey was tucked in. Now it's not.
Stradling goes out wide to left. Clueless comes out. On the other side. Second down and 15. Moyer hands it up the middle. Brown's got it. Dances across the middle and gets met right at the 35-yard line.
Jovan Burris with the textbook tackle. This is the tackle you used to see in Oklahoma drills back in the day. Youth football, this is what the coaches taught you. Ooh, head across the body, into the waist, wrap up. Bring him down. That's how you tackle somebody.
We have a timeout on the field with 10.3 seconds to go here in the first half. It's the Hornets, 42. The Griffins, 6. You're watching Fullerton College Football on Sportsnet, USA.net, in conjunction with Fullerton College TV. Later on tonight, Golden West College against Saddleback. That's also video. Because it's a home game for Golden West College. Make sure you catch up with the franchise on that on SportsnetUSA.net. A little eight-man football. Hey, we were out for eight-man football on SportsnetUSA.net. Ryan Osborne will be out there along with Nathan Percy calling the action. tonight. So you want a little Eat Me in Football, a little audio, just something to keep you occupied? Well, that's on SportsnetUSA.net. If you're a Hornet fan and you're hoping that Golden West finds that miracle, make sure you be watching that game. Rashawn Haylock tonight, 6 o'clock on SportsnetUSA.net. Rashawn Haylock, Andrew King tonight, Golden West College Football on SportsnetUSA.net. Moyer goes back. Third down. Here comes the pressure. He is just swung around with a nice little do-si-do and another sack for the Hornets.
Montre Bronner, 3.5 sacks with that one. Quick off the edge and wraps up. It's a nice way to end the first half of play.
So the end of the first half, as the Hornets are up 42-6, you've been watching Fullerton College Football on SportsnetUSA.net. In conjunction with Fullerton College TV. So, Corey, you look at that first half. Started off, Grossmont looked good. It looked like it was going to be a close game. The Hornets answer. A lot of pushing and shoving, a lot of disgust on the field between the players and the coaches. The first half, the first quarter gets very muddled, to say the least, and takes more time than we thought it should just because of all the stoppage. And then all of a sudden the Hornet offense wakes up. But I'm going to go back and look at you and said, this much non-talked about defense, once again, they give up a touchdown in the first half, and that's it. And, yes, there was confusion on a play where we had an unsportsmanlike conduct call called. We didn't know they were going for two. The Hornets went for two. The officials, if anybody's had a bad day, Grossmont's had a bad day, the officials, they've had a pitiful day in that first half trying to figure out what's going on. But talking about great things, especially with Fullerton College on homecoming day, there they are, the championship dance team. That's right. They're not just a dance team. They're just not a dance team that's good. This is a championship dance team here at Fullerton College. Student athletes on the field spending their time there, Corey. One of the best dance teams in Southern California.
So, Mark, you're going to have David Garcia come in. As soon as he gets the stats from Phil, he'll be a go ahead and read the stats with you.
And I see the lonely man down there in the field, Ryan Osborne, just sort of standing around doing nothing. Ryan, you got nothing to say to me? No love? Okay, I just want to make sure, my friend, you're getting away with too much easy stuff. So, Ryan, I'm going to send it right back down to you, my friend, because you know what? The dance team just got done from one champion to another. Ryan Osborne, why don't you let me know who's down there with you and what this interview is all about?
Well, right now we got Marcus Kirkpatrick with us because it is homecoming. We want to talk to some former Hornets. Marcus, your time as a Hornet, what was your favorite part?
So my favorite part, I believe, is being here on this football field. I mean, Fullerton is probably the best school I've ever played for, you know, better than my high school years and teams in the past that I played for. And just the environment that the coaches have for us, you know, the teammate, the people that, you know, come to play for Fullerton from different places and stuff like that, just being able to meet them and to fellowship with them and be cool with them, you feel me? That's probably the best thing, you know, as a high school kid, not going D1, to be around to experience, because, you know, it's really welcoming. It's a lot of family, you know. And it's crazy how you can build these type of relationships in such a small period of time. I feel like that's the best part. That's what I feel so welcoming at Fullerton College. It's lit.
Now, we talked to you about midway through your freshman season at a basketball game, and you said you love being with the coaches here at Fullerton College. How did the coaches help you progress from then until now?
So, I know the coaches, they really cared about us, you feel me? They really cared about how we performed and what we did on the field, you know, either fights, breakout and stuff like that, you know, how they really want us to just stay disciplined and stuff like that. It's really more than just football, you feel me? It's more like a life discipline type of thing, you know, and I feel like I've learned a lot from them just because they're older and they've been through things, and they tell us these things for a reason, you feel me? So I feel like that's what helped us a lot. And then when we got things going on in our personal lives at home and stuff like that, they always tell us, you know, you guys can come to us, you feel me? Like, we're always here for you. Don't think that just because you're going through something, you guys can't come to us. So I just feel like that's why the program has been so successful, is because the coaches and the players, we really unified, and we have that connection and bond. So I feel like that's why the coaches have helped all of us, and including myself, in developing to be a better man as far as a football player.
From Lake Elsinore out of high school, what made you choose Fullerton College?
I had a couple of boys that I had played against in Elsinore. They went to Lakeside High School, like Ryan Bird and Andre Ponce and Dustin Stolarski, a couple of guys that I knew. I was thinking about going to RCC just because I knew they were good. So I was just like, shoot, let me go over here. And then they started telling me, like, bro, just come over here, come over here. Like, and I was just like, well, shoot. I mean, I ain't get recruited or nothing, so I might as well just go ahead and just go say what's up. And they're like, bro, just come through when we working out, you feel me? And they'll see what's good with you, bro. And I'm like, all right, for sure. So I walked over to, drove with my dad over here when I was still in high school, and I was just like, shoot, I'm trying to play ball. And they were like, okay, where you from? Giving my film and stuff like that. They gave me a tour, and then from there, it was just, it's history, you feel me? We just did our thing, and it was lit.
Last year against Cerritos, you had the interception to seal it. Was that one of your better games in your Fullerton College career?
I feel like that was definitely probably one of the best moments I've had playing football, for sure. I feel like it was just, I feel like the pressure was on, the game was tight, you feel me? And I had just gotten hurt a couple plays prior to that big play. And I just felt like, I just prayed to the Lord, and I was like, Lord, help me, please, you feel me? The team needs me. We're in a critical situation, and, you know, of course, none of us want to lose. And I just felt like pressure was on, and I knew they were coming at me again. So, you know, I just prayed, and I did, and it happened. I honestly can't even tell you how I made that play. I can't even tell you. I watched the film over and over, and the way I came over his body to catch the ball, I still don't even understand. You feel me? And I feel like it's the greatest play I've ever made. You feel me?
How do you think Fullerton College helped you as a person?
Man, I just feel like, you know, just from meeting the players, like I said again, and just being away from my family also, because I love my family and I'm such a family dude, you feel me? So just being away from my family, you know, they're like an hour away in Elsinore, and just being able to separate myself and just know that I'm doing this for my family, for myself, and just knowing that I have a purpose of being here. And it just the environment just helped me, you know, because obviously there's things that I've gone through and stuff like that, but I just feel like the uplifting of my surroundings were just, they helped me just so much, being a better person, just being a better football player, and just, you know, enjoying my life. And I never will regret being a junior college football player.
What was something that while you were here at Fullerton College that the coaches worked on you football-wise?
The greatest thing that I've you know, worked on here was when I came, I had no technique. And when I heard that Coach Austin, he had came from UCLA, and I was like, shoot, you coming from UCLA, you feel me? I'm trying to get to that level, you feel me? So everything he ever said, I just listened to what he said, you know. I know a lot of people be talking in practice or whatever, but every time he said something, I just literally sit there and watch what he was saying, the technique, you know, being patient, stuff like that. I just watched that because I didn't have technique. And when I was first coming, I was getting beat all the time, like all the time. There were so many corners in front of me, and I was just getting beat. And I was like, bro, like, I can't be getting beat like that. I'm trying to play. Like, you know, I was only 17, and I was just like, well, shoot, I'm going to start regardless. You feel me? That was just my mentality. And then when I was really just started implementing what he was saying, it just made me better. It made me so much better because that's what a technique is, everything now. You feel me? A lot of people have athleticism and skill and this and that, but if you have your technique on point, regardless of anything, like, you feel me, you win some, you lose some, but if you got that technique down, it really, longevity-wise, it really gets that work. So I feel like that's, it really improved my game, is that technique I learned from Coach Austin, for real.
Well, thank you, Marcus. Once a Hornet, always a Hornet. Once again, we are with Marcus Kirkpatrick, former Fullerton College Hornet. So we'll send it back up to you guys in the booth.
You know, thanks a lot. I mean, we look at some of the replays that will be happening here in just a second, give you the halftime stats, and we look at Marcus, and I tell you, when he said he was going to go to Riverside because they were so good, I almost hung my head out the booth. As we see the replays here from the Hornets in the first half, and you look at Grossmont in this play, basically on that one, Brown trying to get away in the middle, just couldn't do it. Jordan Hoy, on the other hand, drops the ball on this one, steps up against the pressure, and Jordan Hoy has quick feet. I mean, he's got happy feet. And when you talk about somebody having happy feet, he just glides like that dancer. That's what most dancers have. Happy feet, Jordan Hoy, one more time. on this one. Handed it off to Hewlett. Hewlett getting a great block there, and it looked like the Hornets were going to get back in the end zone as Hewlett has it knocked away at the last second. This is where I thought Grossmont should take a knee instead of trying to run it out. Yeah, it's points that didn't get on the board, but at this stage of the game, it's not really anything except artistically a blemish against the Hornet offense. Once again, the big pressure, the tip and the interception, and this is where the defense doesn't get talked about enough. We should say more about them, but we haven't this year. They've been outstanding. Jordan Hoy back there. This is where we run the modified reverse with a flea flicker at the end. A lot of balls being handled. And then our big tight end, well, he's just strolling down the corner looking for someone to talk to, finds the ball in the air, and another touchdown for him. Our tight ends have been magnificent this year for the Hornets down there. Once again, Hoy doesn't panic when the ball hits the ground, picks it up, looks for a place to go, finds the opening, can outrun people, gives an ankle, takes an ankle away, and in doing so, even when he gets hit from behind, has the balance not to lose the football. On the other side, though, with Moyer, he has been popped more than once, and that's the interception one more time. Great tip drill for a defensive back. Ball goes up, you've got to be able to knock it down. And that brings us to the half, as we're going to bring you the halftime stats here. The Hornets have just played, once again, outstanding. So conference has started. The Hornets look like they should get their first conference win, but we've got a second half of football to go. And when we looked at that first half, well, it looked like it was all Hornet football in that first half, and it really was all Hornet football when you look at the stats in the first half.
So stats for the first half. To start off the game, a touchdown is wiped out by Jordan Hoy. However, Pops Thomas will get the touchdown with the 7-yard run. With the 7-yard run to make it 7-0. Then Grossmont.
So we're going to take a quick break. We'll be back to the stats in a second. Ryan Osborne, we're going through stats, but since you're so lovable and everybody likes to see your pretty little face down there, we're going back down to you on the sideline. Oh, you're going to tell me to wait a second? Well, so let's go back to stats. I'm just going to guide everybody around here. Let's come back in the booth. Keep going until Ryan Osborne's got that pretty face down the sideline.
So like Jordan Hoy's touchdown gets wiped out. I'm going to go ahead and start from the beginning of this. Jordan Hoy's touchdown's wiped out. Pops Thomas picks it up for Fullerton, makes it 7-0 with the 7-yard touchdown run.
And I'm going to take it away from you again. So you're ready down there now, Ryan. Do you got faces that make you look better, or is this one of those things you just shouldn't look at the camera?
Well, Mark, right now I'm with part of the student body government here at Fullerton College since it is the homecoming game, and I'm going to let them introduce themselves.
Hi there. My name is Jameson Obine. Can I just take this? I'm the interclub council president. My job is to basically make sure that club life is flourishing on campus.
Hi, my name is Leigh McCosta-Wilson. I'm the vice president of activities, and my job is to help, you know, promote events and stuff on campus.
Hi, I'm Scott Bagneski. I'm student trustee at Fullerton College. My job is to represent students and AS at district meetings and at their board of trustees meetings, and also, hold on, and then relay what's going on back to AS. Thank you.
My name is Taylor Getchie. I'm the AS vice president, and my job is to make sure that everything's running smoothly around campus and within AS.
Now I'm going to start on this side. What's the most difficult part of your job here at Fullerton College?
Difficult parts. It probably has to be finding the students that are willing to go the extra mile to really put in the work that we all share to make the school a better place. You know, they do exist, but with a commuter school, it is difficult, but we do a good job of addressing it, yeah.
Probably like maintaining positivity, because a lot of the events we do during the year are new, and so people don't really know that much about them, so positivity.
I would say having to represent students is really hard because we have a really big diversity of students. And also there's sometimes you can't make everything happen due to budgets and whatnot, so it's really hard to make the cuts.
The hardest job for me is probably getting more involvement and making sure everyone in AS is involved and active.
Now on this side, you talk about diversity here at Fullerton College. How do you make sure that you guys mix that in?
Like last meeting, we actually had a huge presentation on the faculty of a large of how, like what the diversity is. I think we're at like 50% of the full time is diverse, and it's because they know there's a need for it with students, because I think there's a big Latino population at our school, and there's a lot of research done that the faculty matches the students, that they do pretend to excel in school. So it's really important. But at the same time, there's that balance of trying to find the best candidates as well to the job. So it's really hard trying to get that set. And then over time, we'll definitely be there, especially in Southern California, really diverse for our school.
And for you, what's your favorite part of your job?
My favorite part of my job is probably just getting to know everyone that is in student government. You really form like a really strong connection and a strong bond with everyone. We're like a big family, so I think that's my favorite part of it.
So once again, here at Homecoming, I am with the student body government here at Fullerton College. We'll send it back up to you guys in the booth.
Hey, all I want to know, Ryan Osborne, being a moderator with all the politicians down there, how'd you get them to give you the direct answers? That was amazing, wasn't it?
Yeah. Oh, it was great.
So I'm going back to you now. He did answers. You do numbers. So what were those stats like in the first half?
So Fullerton College leading Grossmont 42-6 at the half. Pops Thomas started off with a 7-yard touchdown run after Jordan Hoy's 2-yard touchdown was wiped out via a flag. Then Grossmont goes down the field. Nehemiah Brown scores on a 10-yard run. However, the extra point was no good, so Fullerton now leads 7-6. Then after turnover on downs, flea flicker, as I heard you talking about, Christian Williams, 65-yard touchdown pass from Jordan Hoy. Then on another turnover on downs, DeAndre McNeil receives a 47-yard pass from Jordan Hoy for Jordan Hoy's second touchdown of the game. Big block on Pops, and that made it 21-6. Then in the second quarter, Christian Williams receives a 14-yard pass from Jordan Hoy, and that made it 28-6. And on fourth down conversion so far through this game, Grossmont is 1-for-3. Then later on in the second quarter, Gerald Hewlett runs it in for Fullerton for 2 yards. And then Jordan Hoy ends the scoring for the Hornets' first half with a 5-yard touchdown run to get back his rushing touchdown. Now he has 20 passing touchdowns on the season with 3 passing touchdowns in the first half, and he adds another rushing touchdown to make it 5 total for the season. Now also third down conversions, Grossmont is struggling offensively. They only have 119 yards total offense, and on third down they are 1-for-9. However, Fullerton on third down is 4-for-7, so their offense is executing a lot better, over 50% on the percentages. But on fourth down, they are keeping drives alive. They are 2-for-2. Brad Cagle, quarterback for Grossmont, he went down with an injury, and when he went down, he was 4-for-4 with 19 yards passing. And Spencer Moyer took over, and since then, Grossmont has not gotten anything going offensively. He is 6-for-23 with 79 yards passing to go along with the pick, and the pressure is getting to him as he has been sacked 3 times in that first half. So that is the first half stats, Fullerton 42, Grossmont 6 here at Homecoming.
And so the teams are getting ready to come back in the field. This is the 100th Homecoming for Fullerton College, and it's not the 100th broadcast for sportsnetusa.net on the air, Ryan Osborne. No, I see you down there, Ryan, looking at me thinking it's the 100th homecoming for myself, but it is the 100th homecoming, and there have been quite an amazing group of people who have gone to Fullerton College through the years. I mean, you can go to Wikipedia and just check the alumni and get taken back by the talent that goes through there, by the talent that is there now, by the educators that are there now. I can't say enough about the educators that I have known through the years at Fullerton College and the educators that are still there at Fullerton College that I have not had the pleasure of taking their classes as they have been there for these past years. It's an outstanding place to go to school and learn at. That's to say the least. It is also a great place to meet the diversity. They talk about it at Fullerton College. It's diverse. And, you know, Dr. Greg Schultz, the president of the college, who just became the new president this year, a wonderful man. Greg will stop and talk to anybody. Open door policy at Fullerton College. You can't say anything nicer than Fullerton College and put Greg's name in the breath. And, of course, when we talk about alumni. Well, Hal Sherbeck, three national championships. Timmy Burns, Brian Crooks, Tom Deep, some of the people on the sideline. Bob Jensen, Gary Krinke, Todd Glenn, Tom Blank, Phil Uchizono. Some of the people that I have known through the years at Fullerton College, Marie Perez over in the TV program, everybody out in the truck that have been there. I tell you what a great place to go to school at, what a great place to learn at, and if you want to take your life and turn it around through academia or just through vocational, there is no better place to go than Fullerton College. It has been the best through all these years. It will continue to be the best, and the future is nothing but bright for those who will go there. Yeah, the statement, once a Hornet, always a Hornet. I have talked to pro football players that are alumnus. I have talked to NCAA champions who are alumnus, and they will all tell you that their life started on the right road here at Fullerton College. You see that right now when you watch the TV broadcast. For everybody that gets the opportunity to watch our wonderful TV department bring you these games from the field when we do all the home games here at Chappelle Field, there is nothing but nice things you can say about these young men and young women and the staff that work on all these games. These are talented, bright individuals that bring the game, and they just make it a lot easier on Corey Neyland and myself. Even when we stumble along the way, they're picking us up by catching the right shot with the right camera angle and showing it to us later. So you want to talk about Fullerton College? Well, you know what their athletic department is like. You know what their television department is like. And I just told you, they've got one of the finer young college presidents running this school. Hey, if you're looking to go to a community college, start tomorrow. Because, yeah, once a Hornet, always a Hornet. And that's a motto we keep alive every day here on Sportsnet. USA.net. Well, let's get ready for the second half as these Hornets are up 42-6. And don't forget, all these games are brought to you by Miller Toyota of Anaheim. Newer used Toyotas, maybe you got to clean up that Toyota you've got. Maybe you just want to look at a new car. Well, you might as well go to Miller Toyota of Anaheim. And what better way to do it? Stop along the way. Hey, early in the morning, been to Miller Toyota, I'm going to go over there. I'm going to stop by Dunkin' Donuts. I'm going to get that fresh brewed coffee, maybe a little hot chocolate instead. You name the donut, they make it. They are fresh, they are sweet, they're exquisite. Dunkin' Donuts right over there on Yorba Linda. Of course, when I get done with Miller Toyota Anaheim, what do? Well, I got to go back home. I'm going to eat later tonight. I'm going to pick myself up a Pep's Pizza with anchovies all over it later tonight. Yeah, it's only for me. I'm not sharing it. A giant, large, extra cheese, extra anchovies. That's right, I'm a California boy who comes from the coast. Pep's Pizza, located on Yorba Linda Boulevard. And in between, if I need a snack, well, I'll go either to Fullerton or to Brea. I'll look for a gourmet burger, maybe some fries, maybe a wrap. Well, I'll go to Islands, either in Fullerton and or Brea, and find myself that gourmet burger, that wrap, or those French fries, and a big Diet Coke, because that's what I'll need at the end of the day. Islands, we want to thank all our sponsors for making all these games possible here on Sportsnet, USA.net. It has been all Hornets in the first half. Don't forget, later on tonight, Golden West College here on Sportsnet, USA.net, taking on Saddleback. If you believe in miracles, you better become a Rustler fan tonight and hope that they can pull that upset. The Hornets will still have to win the rest of the year out to get to that magical championship California game and then the national championship. But they got a lot of work to do as we get ready for another half of football here on Sportsnet, USA.net, in conjunction with Fullerton College TV. All right. Fullerton up 42-6. Let's start the second half of a little football here on Sportsnet, USA.net. Big foot down deep, kicked out of the end zone, so that's going to bring a touchback. It was all Hornets in that first half. Yeah, and we started a little late. That's why we're running a little late. Then we had a little this and a little of that and a little, hey, maybe, and I shouldn't have. Maybe we could have. I did. You did. Maybe they did. I don't know who did. But at the end, it was a very slow first quarter. Now things have picked up. We're into the second half, and we're off and running for the second half of this game here on Sportsnet, USA.net. Moyer brings the team out. First down and 10 at the 25. Looks over the defense. Hands it off. Taken right there at the line of scrimmage. Breaks to the outside. Tries to stay on his feet. Nice little turn on the play. So Brown gets a gain of about five. As we watch it here, Brown comes off a right tackle. Comes out of the pile, stays on his feet, and gets taken down after a gain of five. Second down and five, right at the 30. Moyer goes down, looks to go to Tolbert.
Moyer's pass is incomplete.
And Tolbert, incomplete pass. Got Ryan Osborne up in the booth for a second with me. So Ryan's going to help me out in this first half. He's going to be watching that defense for the Hornets. Big third down and five, Ryan. It's been all Hornets in this first half.
Yeah, and it's something that Fullerton College, you see them down on the sideline. They got really pumped up after that melee in the first quarter. Well, they had to settle down and buckle down. That was the coach's message to them.
Lewis looking to get open. They throw it over the middle. Taken out with a one-handed grab by Guys. And Guys just sticks up his hand and pulls it down.
That was Deshaun Taylor, defensive back for Fullerton College, with the tackle.
Watch Guys on this one. Moyer just throws up, one hands it, and brings it down. Nice little first down play for the Griffins. First down and 10 at the 41. Goes back again, looking. He's got to go down the middle, looks down, intercepted, and it should have been a pick. And I called it a little too early, didn't I, Ryan? Well, I looked like Ryan Osborne with hands out there on that play.
That was you were like Javon Burris on that one, looking ahead for the play before you made the catch.
So Burris, easy little pick, just drops it right there. It's going to bring up a second down and 10 right at the 41. Everybody consoling each other out there. Big second down and 10. Cluis comes out wide left. Tolbert goes out wide to the right. Moyer. His guys go from left to right. Looks back over the sideline. Changes the play. Clock is ticking. Here come the Hornets. They bring the pressure. Throwing it over. One-on-one. D'Angelo Ross against Tolbert. And D'Angelo Ross is a heck of a defensive back.
He is indeed, but Fullerton College on that play, they were bringing out the linebackers. They had Robert Senko coming from the outside for the blitz for Fullerton College. You see him on the outside, and he gets the pressure on the quarterback for Grossmont before he can deliver the ball. That didn't allow him to fully step into his throw.
Brings up a third down and 10 right at the 41. We just started the third quarter, 13:59 to go. It's the Hornets 42, the Griffins 6. Big third down play, and we'll should have a lot of different faces on offense to start this second half. We'll see if that's what the Hornets do. Third down. Hornets looking like they want to bring the pressure. They tighten it up defensively. Almost 11 in the box. Here comes the pressure. Throws it over. Jumps on that, and they miss the interception. Clues has got it. 40, 30, 20, 10. Touchdown, Grossmont. And you jump the route and don't get the pick, you get burned on the play. Ryan?
And right there, you're going to see Tim Gordon jump the route. He tips it, isn't able to get full control of the football, and it just lays right in the hands of Cluis for the touchdown.
And Cluis goes down there. And so Grossmont, even though they're down, they want to feel like they can stay in this game. If they can play the Hornets even in the second half, that'll be a victory. We don't even have coaches in the coaches box here for Grossmont. Estevez comes in for the point after. Ball is spotted. Kick is up. Kick is blocked. Pick up there. D'Angelo Ross. Trying to make it a foot race. If he can take it back, it will be worth 2 points. There's D'Angelo Ross taking it 98 yards on the blocked extra point.
And if you look at D'Angelo Ross, if we get to see the replay, he was on the opposite side. So he was on the opposite side of where that football was blocked. And once D'Angelo picked it up, he made sure that he secured the football. You see him right here. He secures the football, then takes a look upfield. And once he sees that he has some open grass, he only had one guy to beat.
And that right there was Dan Johnson, tight end for Grossmont. And once he got past Johnson, he turns on the afterburners, and he is in there for the two-point conversion for Fullerton College.
So the Hornets give up six, pick up two, and so the net for Grossmont, you're going to Cal State Fullerton. I'm going to keep giving you math.
Net for Grossmont plus four.
Okay, Ryan Osborne, newly accepted student over at Cal State University Fullerton. Congratulations to you, Ryan.
Thank you very much. I've had great teachers here, including yourself.
Thank you. Well, it's been a ball. And I mean, this really, you know, I'm an old alumnus. You're a new alumnus at Fullerton. And it really says we are the epitome of Fullerton College, because it is the young, the old, the ones that have learned, the ones that are learning. You know, that's what makes this community college such a wonderful place to go. 44-12 with 13:49 to go. Mannyweather back deep. Little offside kick in no man's land. Grossmont's got a chance. Do they come up with it? Ball's there. Who's got the football? Grossmont had the opportunity, and Ryan Grossmont pulled off a perfect onside kick and didn't come away with the Easter egg.
Narkeese Smith was the one for Grossmont. If you see him on the far side for the Grossmont Griffins, that one jumps over the Fullerton College Hornet defender. He touches it right there, isn't able to grab it, and that's when Fullerton College swoops in and is able to recover. The one with the recovery is Deshaun Taylor.
So the Hornets will have first and 10 at the 43. Jordan Hoy comes into the game. Grossmont out wide to the right. Jordan Huffman on the outside. Hewlett goes in motion. They go back to the opposite direction. And taken down there on a very good defensive play as Jerome Gross doesn't get anywhere. He's knocked down for a loss on the play.
That was Quantrarius Boone with the tackle.
So it's going to be a loss of nine. Watch this, because they fake the throw to Hewlett, then they go back the opposite direction. That's actually a little flanker screen that doesn't work. Lost a nine on the play. Second down and 19. Jordan Hoy back again. Shotgun formation. Going to hand it off right up the middle. Hands it off to Hewlett. Gain of two on the play.
Boone is in there for the tackle. Second straight time. So the first time, all he has to do is just touch the receiver. This time he's in there to tackle Hewlett by the ankles.
Third down and 16. McNeil comes into the game. Jerome Gross heads for the sideline. Asante Wilder goes from left to right. Grossman in the slot on the right-hand side. McNeil goes far to the left. Jordan Hoy looking over the defense. Third down and 16 for the Hornets. Rolls away from the pressure. Flips it over to Grossman. Grossman gets the block by Wilder. Sidesteps. Cuts the middle. Gives a hip. Gives a hip away. And gets down to the 35. I love the way this young man, who is a wonderful young guy, plays football. They go over. They're looking strictly for Grossman. They throw it to him. And Ryan, he just gives a foot, gives a hip. And Asante Wilder seals the deal with a beautiful block for a first down. Jordan Hoy goes back. Flipping it up all by himself. Picked up by there. And Jordan Hoy gets picked off once again in this game. 40, 30, 20. Taken down from behind as Jordan Ellis goes up and gets the ball. A second interception against Jordan Hoy in the game.
And if you see Ellis, as he goes up for the football, he has to adjust in midair because he sees that that football is going to his back shoulder as the throw is going to be in front of Wilder. He adjusts going from his front shoulder to his back shoulder, makes sure he has the football, lands on 2 feet, enough balance to be able to run it upfield.
With 12 minutes to go in the third quarter, Grossmont again is at the door, getting ready to go in the game. Moyer goes back. Throws it to Tolbert. Tolbert gets a block, turns a corner, stays on his feet, gets run out of bounds right at the nine. Watch this interception again, Ryan, because really this is, you're beaten on the play. If this pass is a foot longer, it's touchdown. Excellent going up, getting the football, turning. Composure is after you catch the ball and running that straight line. That's exactly what he did, as he gets caught from behind or it could have been in. McNeil makes a big defensive play for the Hornets. First down and goal. Throwing over in the flat. Touchdown, Grossmont. So Grossmont goes to Cluas, and we're getting a flag. And usually a flag that's over there. Is it going to be a pick over in the corner? Moyer goes over, throws it to Cluas, and I'm trying to figure out, I don't see what the flag was.
Offsetting penalties.
So you'll see right here, it is offsetting penalties. This is the touchdown pass to Cluas in the corner. The pass is complete. But with the penalties, it looks like it's going to wipe it out. You guys had the situation earlier on in the game where the flags were supposed to come out before the person crossed the goal line. So the flags come out before the reception is made, thus wiping out the score.
So it's first and goal from the 9 again. Throw it right over there. Off the ground, incomplete pass. Once again, they go to Tolbert. Just can't get caught right there. And we have a little conversation as you watch. Watch Tolbert once again, just a slant pattern. Can't get it, Ryan, on the slant pattern, thrown just a little low, and really nice defense over on that left-hand side.
And it's the Fullerton College defense that has played very physical, specifically that secondary. And on that play, it was Taj Jones who was the one to apply the pressure on Tolbert, not allowing him to make the catch.
Second and goal from the 9. Cluas goes in motion from left to right. They go back over the same play, trying to get it to Cluas. D'Angelo Ross was all ready to cut underneath, take it the other way. He's already taken a blocked field goal for 98 yards and 2 points.
Justin Parcells on that play. Middle linebacker for Fullerton College leads the team in tackles. Hesitated for just a moment, then runs right up the gut, applies the pressure to Moyer, and doesn't allow him to step into the throw.
Third and goal from the 9. 11:27 to go here in the third quarter. Fulton, the running back, the lone back in the backfield. Moyer under center. They go back. If it doesn't work the first time, try it the second time. Try it the third time, and it doesn't work again as the defense cuts underneath the slant pattern.
This one was Dwayne Wood. You'll see the pass here. Wood goes underneath it and has a chance to close it to his pad, but was not able to complete the interception.
And Roy Otto made sure and cleaned up the play that nobody was going to bring that in for a touchdown. So it's going to bring up fourth and goal at the 9. And at this stage, 44-12. Grossmont says, we'll get ready for games down the road. We need to punch this in. Here they go, one more time. Right across middle of the field, touchdown. He's not in, and he's short, and it's going to be a stop by the Hornet defense from 9 yards out. Ryan, watch this as you make the sure tackles, and that's the win thing we've talked to Brian Crooks about, making the sure tackles, and Dwayne Wood made sure that nobody was going to get a touchdown on it.
And Wood was able to make that tackle because he had Kletcher as the secondary support. So you'll see the pass being completed. There's Wood with the initial contact. Kletcher comes in to make sure and enforce that the receiver does not get across the goal line. So help defense from Fullerton College, and they keep Grossmont out of the end zone.
Jordan Hoy comes back in at quarterback. I formation, first and 10 on the 1. For the Hornets, they hand it off to Hewlett. Finds an opening, gets across the middle. Gain of about 4 on the play.
Making the tackle there is Roderick Woods, linebacker for Grossmont.
And you watch the lead block by Rashad Harris on the offensive line. Opens up the hole for Hewlett. So Rashad Harris, the freshman out of Daytona Beach, throws a big block for the Hornets. Second down and 6 for the Hornets. Trying to get Grossmont. Jordan Hoy looks over. Resets the offensive line. Taking his time, letting the clock tick. Play clock doesn't worry him. Looks back over, signals to his wides out, and now we're going to get a timeout on the field. So with 10:33 to go here in the third quarter, it's the Hornets 44, the Griffins 12. You're watching Fullerton College Football on Sportsnet, USA.net, in conjunction with Fullerton College TV. And later on tonight, you're going to meet up with Nathan Percy. You're going to be calling a little eight-man football on SportsnetUSA.net. Who's playing tonight?
Well, it's going to be Spirit Academy against the Spartans. And right now, Spirit Academy with a 1-4 record, they have to get this win in order to make sure that they can at least have a 500 season. Because Spirit, they're going to be down a couple players, as a couple players had to miss tests, academia and stuff. So they're going to have to pull together and make sure that Stroud is able to lead them on offense under center. If he's able to get a couple more touchdown passes tonight, Spirit Academy should escape with the win.
So with us running late, you running late, it's probably almost time to say goodbye to you so you can get down.
Yes, indeed.
And do that game, Ryan Osborne. Don't forget the coaches show where?
That is on SportsnetUSA.net. Go to YouTube and type in Orange Voice News right there. SportsnetUSA.net, the coaches show with Ryan Osborne.
There we go. Get out of here. Ryan Osborne on his way to do a little eight-man football on SportsnetUSA.net. Jordan Hoy rolls over, throws it to Grossman. Grossman catches it off his knees, stays on his feet, gets driven out of bounds at the 10-yard line. So we see him go out the flat to Grossman. Grossman trying to catch it right there. He does. It goes down to his knees. He turns. He gets good coverage. Trying to get out to the 10. He gets his foot, and we get a flag on the play. So it's against the Hornets. Going to move him back. They called offside, so the Hornets' outside receivers lined up offsides. Corey Neyland back on the air, Ryan Osborne. Eight-man football later tonight on SportsnetUSA.net. Jordan Hoy pump fakes, rolls away from Jordan Hoy. South steps on getting it and flings it there for a first down. Looks like it's going to be a sack. Looks like it's going to be a safety. And Corey Neyland, he gets a first down.
Yeah, and just a good job of his receiver, Gross, coming back to the ball. That's confidence in your offense, confidence in your quarterback, confidence in your team that you're going to run this type of play in the end zone and wait for your receiver to come back to help your quarterback.
First down and 10 for the Hornets at the 20. Devontae Richardson goes out wide to the right. Grossman out wide to the left. Jordan Hoy in a shotgun formation. Hands it up the middle. Hit right there to the line of scrimmage. That's Hewlett once again. It's 44-12, 9:38 to go. Watch Hewlett go up the middle again. Hewlett hits that line of scrimmage. Looks like he's got an opening, but Grossmont closes it quickly. It's going to gain of one. Second down and 9 for the Hornets. Out wide to the right, Devontae Richardson. Wide to the right. Jordan Hoy in a shotgun formation. Second down and 9. Hoy gives it to Hewlett. Hewlett cuts inside. Off tackle, gets a gain of about 6 on the play.
And Narkee Smith again with the stop. It's his fourth tackle today.
So you see him as he hands it off here. Goes off left tackle. Gets a nice initial lead block and then gets hit there. After he gets his gain, it's going to bring up a third down and 2.
Yeah, just a stretch play. Student body right, student body left. As big Charlie Pescarolo comes in.
Well, no, they brought him back out because Charlie couldn't get out there quick enough.
Oh, okay, so they're going to leave in Lino Vacker.
So third down and 2 for the Hornets at the 28. Jordan Hoy goes back. Little pooch hike. Hoy throws it over in the middle, and this time misses a wide open tight end who says, hey, I'm by myself. I'm just strolling in the garden, and look at this. I'm all alone.
Yeah, because you see the two outside receivers take the corner and the safety deep, one-on-one with the linebacker wide open. That's the worst throw of the day for Jordan Hoy.
So McGahee comes back in to punt it away, averaging almost 40 yards. Last time he kicked it into the end zone, Corey thought it should have been down by special teams. We get a flag on the play, so that play is going to be negated before it even starts. Next week, we're at Saddleback. That game is audio on SportsnetUSA.net. Starts at 6 o'clock.
Hopefully.
What's that mean?
Hopefully it starts at 6
o'clock. Oh, hopefully it starts at 6 o'clock. Yeah, I know. The way games are starting now, what, you know, get there at 4, you start at 7:30.
Remind me to send an email to the Saddleback people.
Okay. Up on the hill by the driving range. Once again, McGahee gets ready. End over end. Brown has it, hit him. Goes off the side. Hornets are down. Ball's picked up. Hornet, first down. So the Hornets, as Sean McConnell comes up with the ball, as Brown has it, hit him high, goes off his chest, and the ball is muffed, and the Hornets recover it.
So is that three or four good special teams play?
Three
for the Hornets. And again, Brown just muffs it. He had it. Too high off the shoulder pads, off the face mask, and tried to come up too high, couldn't bring his hands up. And Fullerton, as opportunistic as they are, tried to pick it up and waltz into the end zone.
Yeah, block punt for a touchdown. Then we had the blocked extra point for 2 points, and then this one right there. Jordan Hoy in the backfield once again. Big first down at the 22, looks over the defense. Goes back, has time, had Pop Thomas in the flat and could have thrown it to Pop, and then tries to go another direction. And Corey, he had Pop all by himself at the last second, was looking for Markell Atkins.
Yeah, and when you're looking next week, when you play teams like Saddleback, you're going to need to go through that check route, that down back right there at the 20. That's Pop Thomas just floating out. You're going to have to get rid of the ball soon because you're not going to have that much time against the Gauchos.
Yeah, and he tried to get it to Atkins, who was going across. So Atkins out wide to the left. Simpson in the slot on the left-hand side. McNeil out wide to the right. Second down and 10 at the 21. Jordan Hoy in the shotgun formation. 44-12, the Hornets are up. He resets the offense. They run the option play with Pop. Pop gets it. It's going to turn the corner. Pop has the speed. Pop Thomas just is a running back that refuses to go down.
Yeah, the first person hit him, and again, the first person is Ryden Kerr. That's six tackles for Ryden Kerr today. And there's the pitch. It was going to be a pitch all the way, but right there, as Pop gets ahead of steam, Kerr is there to slow him down and wrestles him down to the ground.
Hewlett comes back in the game as a running back. Here comes Grossman. Asante Wilder out wide to the right. Jerome Gross out wide to the right. Wilder in the slot on the right-hand side. Out wide left, Jordan Huffman with Grossman in the slot on the left-hand side. Grossman goes in motion from left to right. Jordan Hoy rolls out to the right. Throws it over there. All by himself, Asante Wilder. Touchdown, Hornets.
Too easy. Asante Wilder with his fourth touchdown catch of the season. Jordan Hoy, that's number 21 thrown.
So Jordan Hoy redeeming himself on a couple picks today. You watch this again. He rolls away from the pressure, sets his feet. Wilder, in a dead zone, gets into the end zone.
So that's four touchdowns today, 21 on the season. Averaging almost four touchdowns thrown each game is Jordan Hoy.
We get illegal substitution against Grossmont. And they took they called illegal substitution for Grossmont for having too many. Then they run two more players on, and they looked at the back judge and said, just pick up the flag. Ball is spotted, kick is up, and the kick is good. We get a flag on the play. So once again, Johnny Carmack, as we get offside, Johnny Carmack, the holder, has been perfect for Mr. Aguilar back there. The ball gets spotted, offsides against Grossmont. The kick is good. With 7:11 to go in the third quarter, it's the Hornets 51, Phil Thurman's age, and Grossmont 12. You are watching Fullerton College Football on Sportsnet USA.net in conjunction with Fullerton College TV. World champion cheerleaders, world champion dance squad, world champion alumni. Nothing but great people here at SportsNetUSA.net and Fullerton College. What can I say? And in conjunction with our great camera crew, all the technicians for TV, this would not be happening if it wasn't for Fullerton College TV once again being involved with another great home broadcast here on SportsNetUSA.net. Next week, Saddleback, away game. Later on today, Saddleback takes on Golden West College, the Rustlers. See what they can do. It's a home game for the Rustlers. They're looking for an upset. Big boot kick. Brown takes it over his hand and goes out of bounds.
And apologize for this joke. So you're saying the Rustlers should try to rustle up a victory?
Yeah. Yippee-ki-yay.
Thank you. I'll be here for another quarter.
At least you didn't say you'd be here for another 15 minutes, because that may not be true. Might be another hour and a half. 51-12. Want to thank our stats. We're great at halftime. Got a little description of what happened in that first half of the game.
Okay.
Let everybody know who maybe didn't watch or listen to the game in the first half, how everybody scored, and then what the final stats were for Grossmont and Fullerton. Nice little recap at halftime in the stats. Want to thank our wonderful 145 students for being involved today here on SportsNetUSA.net. Weyer comes out again, looking. Run play right up the middle. Gain of three on the play. 51-12. 7 minutes to go here in the third quarter.
And what I'm impressed with Fullerton, 21 yards in the first half, giving up rushing. And it's a continuation here in the second half. Just stopped them. Good game, but Fullerton doing well. Corey Rose on the stop, as you saw there, and a big number 90.
Lewis and Tolbert go out wide to the right. Moyer under center. Guys, goes from left to right. Moyer looking to go deep. Gets hit as the ball's thrown up. Picked right there by D'Angelo Ross. D'Angelo Ross, touchdown.
D'Angelo Ross may be the smartest player on the Fullerton College team. If you have this replay, watch him read the route before it even happens. This is his second touchdown return of the season. And he reads the route. He's there even before the quarterback throws it, because he's back here. He lets his man go. He sees Clewis come up and do that little corner route, and he's there for the interception. Wasn't even close. D'Angelo Ross, my defensive player of the year so far.
So D'Angelo Ross, back-to-back weeks. And now the Hornets are trying to put up their 58th point on the board with 6:27 to go here in the third quarter. Ball is spotted, kick is up, and the kick is good. It's the Hornets 58, Grossmont 12. You are watching Fullerton College football on Sportsnet, USA.net. Corey, you talk about this team. There are so many components of this Hornet team. There are so many individuals. And here's my cliche. It's a team game. These individual players have bought into the team game aspect.
Yes, they have. And D'Angelo Ross, the outstanding season, 3 interceptions, 2 returned for a touchdown, and that blocked extra point return for a touchdown as well. Like you said, he's one good individual component who's bought into this team system. And it is really a new attitude. We saw it in the preseason. It's continued on here. And you just wonder how far it can take this Fullerton Hornet team buying into the system and everybody clicking on all cylinders.
Well, and you walked into your first conference game and everybody said, yeah, Grossmont, they're 4-1. We'll see what happens. You and I looked at each other and thought this was going to be a closer game than it is. And at the end of the day, the Hornets are doing what they've done to everyone else. Realize the least amount of points they've scored, 31 so far this season. Brown takes it in the end zone. He's going to bring it out. Brown at the 10, cuts to the outside, tries to turn the corner, gets driven out of bounds right at the 20-yard line.
Well, they lead the state in scoring with 52. I mean, they average 52 points a game. 2013, that record-setting team averaged 47. this team shows no signs of slowing down at all. I mean, we thought it was 7-6 in the first quarter. Okay, Grossmont better than they have been the last few years. This is going to be a good game.
Yeah, I agree with you. I thought maybe somebody asked me, they said, what do you think the score is going to be? And I said, probably 35-21. It's going to be a close game, but Fullerton's going to prevail. If somebody would have said to me, hey, you got 6 minutes to go in the third quarter and the Hornets are up by 46, I'd have said, yeah, I don't think so. So Moyer brings him out. Out wide left is going to be slow. Out wide left is going to be Vincent. Moyer's going to hand it up the middle. And the defense just once again. And Corey, I mean, Brian's going deep with this defense out there, that even their threes and their fours are playing great football for the defense.
And we'll set that defense in just a moment.
Gain a three on the play. It's going to bring it down. Second down and 7. Homecoming. Nice little turnout for the Hornets. We'd like to see 5,000 in the pass. Got to promote community college sports. What a great ticket it is. You've got nothing to do. Moyer goes back once again. Going to throw it out the flat. This time turns it out there. Gain of a first down. Did they get across the marker before they went out? They're going to mark him right at the first down marker. It'll be first down and 10 for Grossmont. So it'll be first down and 10 at the 29.
All right, Mark up front. Corey Rose, Mitchell Hurtado, and Jalen Dean go along with J.J. Smith. Backers are Devin Hessler, Cody Darrow, and Cole McCarty.
Moyer looks it over. Here comes the defense. Trying to go over here deep. Looking for Vincent on a fly pattern. Incomplete pass.
And in that secondary, that coverage applied by Andre Pierman. As you see the replay here, Andre Pierman, number 15 in blue. You see him stumbling, but he's step for step with Vincent. On the other side, David Richardson, and the safeties are Dwayne Wood, who's had a solid game, and Steve Everett.
Vincent comes out wide left. Tolbert goes out wide right. Brown in the backfield. Guys in the slot on the left-hand side. Moyer in a shotgun formation. Second down and 10. Goes back. Here comes the pressure and a little screen pass. Up in the air. Almost picked. Picked by the Hornets. They got to call it an interception?
Yes, they should.
Interception for the Hornets.
And it was tipped by Devin Hessler and picked off on the ground by Cody Darrow. Watch the replay, Mark. You'll see the screenplay coming up. Good pressure by McCarty. Tipped by Hessler there. Darrow makes an outstanding catch to pick it off.
Wow, he went down. I thought it was going to hit the turf, and Corey, that really was. That was athletic,
and
to
I
say
should,
the least.
And I should say Darrow. That's Cody. And just an athletic play by somebody, 6'2", 225, getting down to the ground. Devin Hessler sniffed out and just blew up the screen. I mean, there was no chance. And right there, ball doesn't even touch the ground. He secures it. Excellent play by the Hornets.
Isaiah Jackson now in a quarterback for the Hornets. First down and 10. Jackson goes back. Shrugs off one. Jackson throws over the middle of the field. Right there. So Jackson himself, Corey, just feels that acrobatic and gets at the Jordan Huffman coming across the field.
And again, there's no sweat. No pressure. Just keeps his cool and makes the play.
First down and 10. Right at 16. Goes back again looking for Jordan Huffman. Back shoulder pass. Touchdown, Hornets. So Jordan Huffman goes back and catches that one. And once again, watches, because this is a beautiful back shoulder pass by Isaiah to Jordan Huffman. Huffman's the only one that can catch that football.
And he was working, and Isaiah Jackson had plenty of time to throw. Working behind Lino Vacker, Marshall Levins, Muhammad Jefferson, Rashad Harris, and Matthew Hanau.
Johnny Carmack in as a holder. Aguilar trying to stay perfect with extra points. Ball is spotted. Kick is up. And the kick is good. So the Hornets now 65-12. It's Fullerton 65, Grossmont 12. You're watching Fullerton College Football on Sportsnet, USA.net. Corey Neyland, Mark Pavlovich, Ryan Osborne, he left the field. He's heading for eight-man football. And the Hornets just keep racking it up. 65. Last week, it was 62-6 against Moore Park. Week before, 56-35 against Mount Sac. Against Canyons, 59-14. Cerritos, 31-19. And then key to the county game, 56-17. The offense prolific, the defense dynamic, the special teams, they're just inviting when you watch them play, and the Hornets feel like they have a team that might take them where Hal Sherbeck has been before. Deep kick. Clueless is going to take the knee. And you know, let's talk about Tim Burns and this entire staff that he's got out here. And you've got Brian Crooks and all these wonderful coaches for this Hornet team that are out here. I mean, you got Garrett Campbell, offensive coordinator. Brian Crooks, defensive coordinator. Phil Austin, associate head coach. Kevin Sampson, offensive assistant. Dick Campbell, offensive assistant. Trevor Waters, offensive line coach. Andrew Felden, offensive line coach. James Griffin, wide receiver coach. Just some of the great educators are out here with this Fullerton team. Moyer, once again, hands it back, swallowed up in the backfield, not being on the full play. That's Jaylon Dean from Pomona, 5'10", 510 pounds. As you watch him try to run the little delay, and Dean is just all over that as Jaylon Dean makes the big play for the Hornets for a four-yard loss.
Did you just call him 510 pounds?
No, I didn't call him that big.
Jaylon Dean, 5'10", 250 pounds?
Yeah.
Sure sounded like it. You just do not like big people, do you, Mark? I'm surprised you like me.
Second down. Moyer says, somebody's got to go get the ball, and Grossmont says, don't throw it to me, as Dan Johnson says, I caught it, but I lost my helmet. And the Hornets go over Corey after a contentious start, politely hand him his helmet back.
Paul Sims with the stop. And so, the Griffins just haven't been able to get anything going. I mean, that was just sniffed out, snuffed out, stuffed out, stuffed, stopped, halted.
Lewis comes out wide to the left. Tolbert comes out wide to the right. Moyer looking for it. Stands, waits. Almost picked. And broke up at the last second, so it's going to bring up a fourth down.
I'm not quite sure the way this game is going that I wouldn't have thrown a flag on that play. Because you got the play just a little bit overthrown. And this is what upsets me about the big hitters. If you're playing the ball,
you got to pick.
You got an interception. Instead, you're trying, hurting the receiver, hurting yourself. Go for the pick. I miss those days.
Sante Wilder back deep. Standing at the 40. 3:50 to go. Sante Wilder signals for a fair catch and takes it there right at the 42. With 3:43 to go here in the third quarter, it's Fullerton 65, Grossmont 12. You're watching Fullerton College Football on Sportsnet, USA.net. Some of the other wonderful coaches out there, as we've got a flag on the play. Dave Robinson, defensive line coach. Brian Burks, defensive line coach. Robert Miranda, defensive line coach and long snappers out there. Steve Valabuena, special teams. Kevin Marino, defensive back coach.
He was on that 2003-2004 teams.
Kevin Marino?
Yes, he was. Linebacker, defensive back, did everything for him, all conference.
Damian Porter, defensive back coach. Ken Lutz, linebacker coach. Sean McCormick, defensive student assistant. And Tom Deep, who's down there, equipment manager, defensive coach, spiritual leader.
All-around good guy, big, sexy. I love him.
Love them down there. I tell you what, these are just an outstanding group of educators that happen to be coaches. And that's the one thing we can't emphasize enough here on SportsnetUSA.net. When you talk about athletics, don't forget, these young men and these young women that coach these teams are educators. Fullerton, first down and 10, right at the 44. Isaiah Jackson comes out at quarterback. First down and 10 for the Hornets at the 44. 65 to 12. Hands it off right up the middle one more time as he gives it to Andre Carter. And Andre Carter, who's got a little giddy up in his step too, gets a big gain on the play.
Yeah, he's got two touchdowns. Simple trap play. Coming on the opposite side, picking up a positive gain.
Second down and 4 for the Hornets. Right at the 38.
And Mark, you wondered about the wait time of the game. It's supposed to start at 1. It started about 2:10. Both teams amped up, ready to play.
Hand it off Carter again. Carter goes off the left side again. This time he gets to the 35.
And Fullerton comes up, and they were unfazed by the wait. They executed their game plan, and they've just been impressive. And just another quick handoff.
Yeah. Well, yeah, you've got to be impressed with Fullerton. They didn't let the delay bother them.
No.
It's going to bring up a third down and 2. Hornets come to the line of scrimmage. Isaiah hands it off this time, fakes it, stays on. Big hit by a quarterback, drops his head, drops his shoulder. First down for the Hornets as he fakes it on the run and goes straight up the middle, move the chains for Fullerton.
And Juarez Lewis is there. He's had a busy afternoon. Just fakes the handoff, gets up. Juarez Lewis on the stop. Cole Kidd, another multi-tackle game.
Robert Johnson out wide to the right. High formation for the Hornets. Jackson hands it off to Carter. Trying to get the corner. Gets the corner. Sticks it there. One more step. Just gets knocked down at the 15. If he gets that one more step, he's off and running.
Luckman Barku makes the stop. And again, Mark, Andre Carter, the fastest back they have. And it's just a sweet play. He splayed across the line of scrimmage and picks up the first down. But again, hat on hat, offensive linemen, receivers doing their job.
First down and 10 for the Hornets. On the 12, they're moving.
Grossmont's defense only gave up 105 yards a game as a defense, 322 total. In the first half, Fullerton had 381, 147, and 234 passing.
Jackson looking over. This time, runs a little delay, hands it off. Once again, up the middle, just a nice little play for Carter. Carter gets maybe a yard on the play. It's going to bring up a big third down.
You know, Kerr, they should have said there was a brick wall right at the line of scrimmage and not run it straight into it.
Well, and you know, you feel bad for Grossmont, but the Grossmont offense really hasn't helped the Grossmont defense at all. Defense made a couple picks. Offense hasn't done anything to help them in this game.
And I'm going to say that's Fullerton's defense.
Okay.
Because Grossmont's offense wasn't able to find any type of rhythm. They're a better offense than what they've shown tonight, today.
Jackson throws it out in the flat, taken there, driven out of bounds. A nice little pitch by Jackson to Devontae Richardson. Richardson goes out there and pulls it down.
And again, Jackson strong arms it to the outside. He's got a live wire, live arm.
Jackson looks over, third down and 4. Right up the middle, touchdown, Fullerton College. Number 3 on the season. So Carter goes right up the middle, and that little 5'9", 165-pound freshman, straight dive play. Well, that was a previous play, but goes right up the middle for a touchdown.
And Andre Carter out of Crenshaw High School. Scoring record, Fullerton has 79 points is the scoring record for Fullerton. And they're at 71 now with 18.5 seconds to play. And Phil Thurman, they scored 79 in 2013 against Grossmont.
Ball is spotted, kick is up, and the kick is good. So the Hornets, 72, Grossmont 12.
And you watch the handoff right out the middle. Andre Carter was just so fast. Remember watching the highlights of him at Crenshaw a couple years ago? He is just so quick. An abundance of talent and an abundance of riches Fullerton College has. Now if we can just get them in them black and gold, be perfect.
You know, Corey, here's the thing, too. When you talk about abundance of riches.
Oh, Tom, speaking of abundance of riches, Tom Duff.
Oh, you know what? And we didn't. No. Tom, it's homecoming. Shame on us. Talk about an alumni that we didn't mention during this game. Thank you for everything you've done to us. We miss you. Corey and I had a chair waiting for you. You were going to sit right behind Mr. Neyland. You're going to be giving us a lot of nods.
You know why we love Tom here? Because he gives. He's like a historian Fullerton College and a historian of Fullerton College athletics. And it's good to talk to him about, okay, is this the best team? We would love to have Tom here.
Oh, yeah, wouldn't it? Because he would take us back to those championship undefeated teams in 65, 67, 83 and say, I don't know, they might not have been able to play with those guys.
Well, he can give us perspective because I remember a few years back, and when I talk about a few years, I mean like 6 or 7, Marquise Avery, when he was doing the big things at wide receiver, breaking all the records, Tom Duff sat in the corner. Yeah, Marquise is good, very good, great Hornet. But Rich Leon's the best receiver out of Fullerton College. And he just looked and said, okay. And then he backed it up. So that's what we need.
Yeah, and Tom, we hope you stuck around. We miss you. You know, we know everybody can't make every game, but, boy, we hope you'll be with us at least for one home game here on SportsnetUSA.net. And, Tom, if they get lucky enough to get to the end of the rainbow, Corey and I will come pick you up for that
game. Yeah, we're picking you up ourselves.
We're bringing you out here when we broadcast it because we're gonna give Tom Duff a microphone.
Me, Mark, Gabriella, Tom, all rolling deep to the state championship.
That's it. So we come to the end of the third quarter. As we come to the end of the third quarter, it's the Hornets 72. The Griffins 12. You're watching Fullerton College Football on SportsnetUSA.net. Remember, Miller Toyota of Anaheim. Miller Toyota of Anaheim sponsors community college sports, high school sports, but most of all, education. That's Miller Toyota of Anaheim. Get up early in the morning, need that cup of coffee, just can't get moving. Hey, no better place to go down to and just inhale the greatness of the pastries they make. Dunkin' Donuts on Yorba Linda Boulevard, 4 o'clock in the morning till 11 o'clock at night. And then as the day moves on, well, Pep's Pizza, you name it, you got it, you throw it on a pizza, that's Pep's Pizza. I tell you what, dough, taste, that's the best. And, of course, every Sunday, head on over to Islands, either in Brea or Fullerton. Islands, gourmet burgers and french fries. Some of the best burgers, french fries, and wraps around Southern California. That's Islands here. All sponsors on SportsnetUSA.net. I got to thank Anderson Lynn Accounting. I haven't talked about them. Anderson Lynn Accounting, making sure this is all possible. Also on SportsnetUSA.net. Anderson Lynn Accounting is actually all the accountants and tax people for all the Fullerton College coaches out there. Grossmont, looking to get on the board. Taken down. Quickly on the play is Tyler Guys.
Pass completed to Guys, brought down by number 28.
Corey Neyland will probably tell you some new names that Brian Crooks has got out there defensively. As we just start the fourth quarter, it's the Hornets 72. Grossmont 12 here on SportsnetUSA.net in conjunction with Fullerton College TV. Don't forget, 90.1 FM, KBPK. That's right, best music, best sound, 90.1 FM, KBPK. First down and 10. Fullerton comes. Little bobble. Swallowed up in the backfield. The scrum is pushing. They're going to call him down. That's going to be another sack for this Hornet defense. And this all started by a bobbled snap as it goes down. And then you see the defense come in there and just make the big stop. Second down and 10 right at the 36.
So those new guys in there, Jalen Dean as well as Wayne Sumpner was in there, forced that bobbled snap. Alan Robles and Jonathan Snowden up front, A.J. Otto, Wallace Payton, and Oscar Sanchez, the linebackers. Quentin Mercado, Derek Fletcher, Steve Everett in the secondary with Daniel Robinson.
Moyer, a little quick in route across the middle of the field. Gets a gain of 7 on the play. As Javon Burris, you watch Javon Burris just goes down, turns in. That's all he does. There's a little turn in and then just catches it right there at the 30, at the 45.
Wallace Payton there along with Sanchez.
Third down and 2. Burris in the slot on the left-hand side. Moyer goes back. Here comes the pressure. Throws it out there in the flat. And there is a play that should have been a first down. And, Corey, what happened is when you look at it, Vincent just doesn't stretch out to catch the football. So it's going to bring up fourth down and 1 at the 45. Fullerton, one too many players on the field. Can he get off in time? We should have a flag against the Hornets for 12 players on the field.
And that 5 yards on that fourth and 2 is going to pick up the first down. And the Griffins will move the chains and try to put more points on the board as Fullerton is up 72-12.
Jalon Dean trying to get off the field out of Pomona.
Jalen out of Ganesha High School.
So we get a little timeout on the field. Brian Crooks talking to the defense that's out there. Don't you love our coaches? You're up 72-12. Game's probably over. It's the fourth quarter, 12:23 to go. And what are they doing? They're coaching. These are educators out there teaching the game all the time. This is what they do in the classroom, which is the practice field. At the field house, what an outstanding group of men these trainers, these coaches are out here. And speaking of our trainer, well, Juan Cuevas, he's always down there taking care of the nicks, bruises, and everything else that's going on. Juan Cuevas, the best trainer in Southern California. Moyer looks back, looking over, flips over to the left, ball up in the air, incomplete pass on a fourth down. And the Hornets are going to get the ball back on a turnover.
Wait, it was fourth down? Shouldn't that 5-yard penalty brought him to first down?
Yeah,
was it offsetting penalties?
It was, yeah, it must have been. I didn't see the other flag.
Okay, well, Wallace Payton deflects it and it goes down. Phil Thurman, what time is the game versus Saddleback? It says 1 in here. 6? Okay, so it is 6 o'clock. All right. So 6 p.m. next week versus Saddleback. So tune in to sportsnetusa.net.
Hey, Phil, are you going to be there at 6 o'clock next week?
I'll be there at 1. I don't want to miss it.
First down and 10 for the Hornets at the 45. Nice little run taken out. Defense steps up really big as Carter can't make the turn.
Cole Kidd stops him in his tracks. Watch Cole Kidd step up and fill. Johnny Carmack hands it to him, and there was just nowhere to go on the outside.
So Johnny Carmack now in at quarterback for the Hornets. Of course, here Johnny mentioned all the time, he holds the extra points. He's got great hands, great young quarterback, and really nice young man. Out wide to the right, Devontae Richards. Carmack hands it off to Carter. Carter goes up the middle. Doesn't get back to the original line of scrimmage.
And again, Cole Kidd shoots the gap and shoots that A gap and comes through.
So it's a third down and 15 at the 50 for the Hornets. 72-12, 11:22 to go. Carter in the backfield, Carmack the quarterback. Richardson goes out wide to the left. Carmack has time to throw, steps up, dances, gets away from one, tries to get away from another, gets sandwiched right at the 50-yard line.
And up. And, Mark, you watch Johnny Carmack. He didn't look like he was going to throw the ball down the field. And I'll bring up big fourth down. That offensive line was Andrew Brantley, Allen Robles was in there. Andrew Brantley, John Anderson was in the game, and Stephen Angel up front, those new guys. And John Anderson, you also want to say hi to his dad, his uncle, and Maggie, his mom. Philadelphia made that trek down this week. And you'll also be able to see John's dad and his uncle. Ryan Osborne got a chance to interview him. Pay attention to the coaches show on SportsnetUSA.net next week.
Yeah, it gets loaded up. Gets loaded up every Thursday. You can end up finding the coaches show at Ryan Osborne. Always visit with a coach and or a player, mostly football. Some of the other sports that are currently going on. He's done a little couple volleyball interviews. So Fullerton gets marched back five more yards. McGahee. Nice. High spiral to Brown. Brown signals for a fair catch. Takes it back all the way at the 14. We're at the 10-minute mark. 9 minutes and 59 seconds. It's the Hornet, 72. Grossmont, 12. You're watching Fullerton College Football on Sportsnet, USA.net, in conjunction with Fullerton College TV.
You know, Mark, that's precisely what I was thinking.
Really?
Yes.
Don't you love the directors when they're right?
Oh,
they
yeah.
Know exactly what to say. You know what? I've got the feeling this is going to be a 15-second wrap-up.
I have a feeling that as soon as that clock hits zero, we gone.
72-12. It's been all Hornets. Next week, Saddleback. The Hornets are 6-0. Saddleback, 5-0 right now. They play against the Rustlers, who on paper don't look like it should be a game against Saddleback.
And it shouldn't.
Okay.
I've seen them on film. And Mark? But I just hope they rustle up something. And I was thinking, even the Dodger Nationals, people who watched the game on Thursday, said this game was long.
Yeah, I would imagine. Moyer throws it out there. Almost picked on that one. Incomplete pass, second down and 10. Well, it started late. The referees didn't get here in time. We get the replay, and you see Moyer. Moyer's had a very tough day. His first half stats, he was 6 of 23, Corey, and this is a young backup quarterback that just never has felt right in the pocket against this very determined Hornet defense. SID down there going through the record book all the way down on the left. Clueless out wide left. Going to run a little delay play. Hornet defense all over that. Brown gets away, just squirms his way like a piece of silly putty and gets a gain on the play.
And Derek Fletcher out of Fullerton High School, you see him break through. Stopped at the line of scrimmage there, but the quick feet of Brown just continuing to move. And Derek Fletcher at home makes it a third and long.
Third down and 9. Right at the 30. Moyer looks over things. Defense comes up. They're bringing the pressure. He goes back. Three-step drop. Trying to get it. Hit. It's going to be short. They're going to mark him at the 35. He needs to get to the 39. And if you're Grossmont, do you just say at this stage of the game, let's go for it?
No. You kick it away. I mean, you've got no rhythm. It's like wearing itchy underwear. You're always moving. You can't sit still. You can't get comfortable. And you just, matter of fact, you know, just kick the ball away, take them off, wash another one, and wear some new ones.
You know, if I was the TV department, I might move a little back from the door on that side. So they're going to punt it away. Semi-rush by the Hornets. Taken there. Simpson at the 40. He's got a convoy at the 50, at the 40. Well, that's Mannyweather. Mannyweather stays on his feet, cuts back in, and Mannyweather
on the return.
Brings it all the way down to the 20-yard line.
Brought down by Johnny Garcia.
So Mannyweather brings the return. Time you watch Manny Weather here, Corey, and really no rush. Manny Weather comes up. Nonchalance it.
And it's a 50-yard return. And it's just one of those things that he has a lane, and right there, that slows him up. That was Tafe Tuia who slows him up just enough for his teammates to come and make the tackle.
So the Hornets get it down to the 20-yard line. Carmack in at quarterback. Carmack takes it himself, looks for a turn, stays on his feet, gets knocked out of bounds, ball comes out, and we get a shove right at there at the end. And you know, I'm sure it's still a little chippy because I'm sure people are talking to each other now down the field.
And Carmack's got to realize, stay in bounds. Do not stop the clock, and they're winding it now. And new quarterback in the game for Fullerton.
Nick Garcia is now in at quarterback. So Garcia in at quarterback for the Hornets. I formation. Second down and six. Garcia takes a chance, puts it up, throws it up. Just short arms it there. If he throws it on the money, that's touchdown.
And he rushed it. He rushed it, and that made him short arm to throw because his receiver on a nice little
Matt Donaldson.
For number 10, Matt Donaldson
was out there. You watch it here, Corey, and he's got time. Donaldson gets open. Donaldson's got the play. So it's going to bring up a third down and six. Carter goes from left to right. Garcia throws it out in the flat. Tries to drive him out of bounds on another little pitch and catch right there to Devontae Richardson. And Richardson makes a nice little catch. Richardson's played a lot of game today.
And that's just nice pitch, nice catch. Get yourself a first down, move the chains.
So Richardson goes out wide to the left. Garcia, quarterback. Hands it off to Carter, who gets hit by one, gets hit by two. Says, how many players are on a team? I think all 11 hit me. As he goes down with 7:15 to go. 72-12. The Hornets up by 60. You watch Carter. He gets initially hit in the backfield, then gets hit again by the entire defensive line of Grossmont.
And Johnny Garcia was the one that blew it up. In the backfield, Carter just did a nice job of getting back close to the line of scrimmage. So they're at the 6-yard line mark. 6 yards to go to get 78 points and an extra point to match.
Hand it off to Carter. Carter's got blockers out in front of him. He's got to turn the corner, stays on his feet, goes towards the sideline. He's going to be short.
And you can tell Carter likes to get to the outside because if he takes this one off tackle and cuts up the field sooner, he's got a better chance to get into the end zone.
So third down.
You're going to call it at the 3-yard line.
Hornets trying to shuffle people in right and left. Bailey Wolf now in the game, out wide to the left. Nick Garcia looks over it over. Get a little motion. We get a flag against the Hornets. It's going to be illegal procedure with motion in the slot. Sort of feel like IRS is here, don't you? You didn't pay your back taxes and they're taking your furniture.
That's why I don't have any furniture. So I don't have that problem.
Turn around the booth. Things are disappearing. Illegal procedure against the Hornets. So they're going to move it back. Garcia looks. Carter in the backfield. Wolf in the slot on left-hand side. Just came in the game. And it's straight up to Carter. Carter gets taken down immediately. 5 minutes and 20 seconds.
So Phil Thurman is not going to get his wish of Fullerton College getting 79 points, matching the career record in points per game, per points in a game.
Fourth and goal for the Hornets. They need a touchdown to tie the record. Here comes the blitz. Grossmont comes up, stumbles defensively at the line of scrimmage. Carmack calls him off. Once again, and it's straight up the middle. Stays on his feet. And the Hornets are
touchdown. So Andre Carter right up the middle, easy as 1, 2, 3. Four touchdowns for Andre Carter on the season. And they're at 78 points.
I think they ought to just challenge Phil and go for two, right? Just to.
No, that's karma. You can't mess with karma.
Oh, okay.
You can't go for two at this time.
Ball is spotted. Kick is up. And the kick is good.
So the 2016 Fullerton College Hornet football team matches the most points scored in a game in their 100-year history against the same team they set it against in 2013, 79 points.
It's homecoming, 100 years. What else would you do for homecoming? Homecoming record. 100 years of football, 79 points today. And the continuation of an undefeated season. And here's the other thing, 79 points for. Defense is relaxed, 12 points. And one of those touchdowns comes because defensive back jumps the route, tips the ball in the air, Cluis brings it down and scampers in for the touchdown.
Yeah, we were coming back. We were on the sideline for that play, and you saw the tip. Tim Gordon thought he had it. And Cluis comes down with it, and he just outraced it. Everybody. I mean, it was a fun play down there on the field because Fullerton's whole defense was upset because, man, they weren't upset about the touch. Well, they were upset about the touchdown, but it's like they were having fun out there even though they scored. That's what you've been missing the last couple years.
And, I mean, Corey and I can tell you the offense is just fun to watch. They're exciting. They're inventive. They're innovative. But the defense, Corey, four deep. I keep waiting for the defense just to say, oh, well, the fours are playing. Yeah. And the number ones are still out there for Grossmont. Don't get us wrong. Grossmont hasn't been playing their fours. First down and 10 at the 35. Right up the middle, gain of 9 on the play.
And for his first run, Isaac Martinez out of Chula Vista. Just runs right off the tackle, right off his shoulder. Cuts the gain. Nice moving, and Steve Everett's there to put a stop to that run.
But that's the first time we've seen somebody besides Brown or Fulton
be
in the backfield. The wide receivers, Cluis, Tolbert, they've been out there all day long. Yeah, their starting quarterback, Cagle, got hurt early. The backup came in. But the defense on all levels has played well today once again. Burn me once, shame on me. Burn me twice, shame on you. As the defense comes up and makes a big stop right there.
And Alan Robles and Eric Rendon said, no shame in our game. And they put him down.
By number 46, Eric Rendon.
So the defense still playing hard for Brian Crooks as we tick down close to the 3-minute mark, 79-12. Will there be a pick? Can they get to 85? Okay.
We'll see if they can get that pick, if they put the ball in the air.
Once again, right up the middle, enough for a first down. It looks like Grossmont's going to move the chains.
And, Mark, I don't see.
As Martinez moves it across for a first down.
I don't think you'll see another throw.
Okay.
I'd be surprised if we do.
We're at the 3-minute mark. Yeah, that's right. We're coming to the end. It's the Hornets chugging along at 79. Grossmont 12. You've been watching Fullerton College football on Sportsnet, USA.net, in conjunction with Fullerton College TV. First down and 10, right at the 48. Moyer goes back. Here comes the pressure. Ball thrown up right there in the hand. 30, 20. It's going to get it in. Gets knocked out of bounds. They're going to give him a touchdown. Touchdown right there, taken out of the air by Smith, who beats his defensive back and gets a touchdown.
So Marcellus Smith beats Kenneth Turner, or skinny Kenneth Griffin, as Griffin just falls down, slips, can't get up, and scores the touchdown and outrunning Steve Everett for the 18th point of the game for the Griffins.
So the Hornets will get the ball back with 2:36 to go.
And Brian Crooks is not happy as you look at this different angle, as you see them on a corner route. Good pass, good catch. And when all you have to do is high step it down the sideline, you got a chance to score, you do it.
Well, I hope he doesn't say somebody up in the booth was giving too much love to his fours.
Actually, the defense heard the other guy say they're not going to throw it.
Ted, they go back for a two-point. Thrown there, incomplete, as Grossmont goes for a two-point conversion and just can't pull it off. So the Hornets are going to get the ball back with 2:36 to go. It's your Fullerton College Hornets 79, Grossmont 18. You've been watching Fullerton College football on Sportsnet, USA.net. Want to give love to Military Yacht of Anaheim, Island, Dunkin' Donuts, Pep's Pizza, and Anderson Lynn. Accounting for making all these games possible for our biggest donor, Tom Dutt. Thank you, Tom. It's always a ball. It's more fun when you're more out here. To the Fullerton College TV department, again, a wonderful broadcast. All the shots, the instant replay. Talented, wonderful individuals making this game possible here on SportsnetUSA.net. Ryan Osborne, who's already vacated the premises and is getting ready for eight-man football.
And Mark, Fullerton College has lived up to their stats this season. Jordan Hoy, eighth in the state in passing. 17 touchdowns, two interceptions coming into this game, 21 now and four. And again, eighth in the state. Cagle was 19th in the state in passing, but he got hurt in that first quarter, and then it's just been all Fullerton.
Well, they were going to take a knee. Then they decided to bring it out, go down at the 15.
And, Mark, how well did this Fullerton College defense play? Adrian Tolbert was sixth in the state in passing, in receiving. He hasn't done much. He didn't do anything today.
He disappeared.
Yeah, because the Fullerton College made him disappear. Aguilar, the kicker, Jonathan Aguilar, second in the state in kicking.
Yeah, this team keeps scoring. He keeps doing what he's doing. You're going to just go, wow.
Yeah, and you look at total offense in the state. Saddleback 3, Fullerton 8, Grossmont 20. And total defense, Fullerton 8, Grossmont 20. That's in the state. That's 70 teams that you look at in the state. And Fullerton and Grossmont is right up there. But Fullerton just on another level.
And the officials, once again, they marked it off against Grossmont, realized, oh, we just did that against the wrong team. We got to go back the other direction. Hey, guys, don't worry. 2:32 to go, and then you get to go maybe do a little eight-man football with Ryan Osborne. Carmack comes out at quarterback, first down and 10 for the Hornets. Throws it out here in the flat. Pitch a catch, nice little catch, taken out of bounds right there by Gonzalez. Wide receiver out of Brea, California.
So Elijah getting some action. That's his first catch of the season.
Look at Elijah take it out there. Corey comes up, gets a nice little block.
But the bad thing about the play, he stepped out of bounds.
That's it.
That's not good.
Get offsides against Grossmont. That's going to move it again. Going to be a first down. First down and 10. Carmack takes it himself, looking to turn the corner. Johnny Carmack stays on his feet, gets wrestled, stays inbounds.
Okay. He stayed inbounds. Okay, because I was going to say, next play up the middle.
A two-minute mark. You watch Carmack roll out to the right, gets to the sidelines, and he was – what I like about the officials, Corey, he was thrown out of bounds, and the official just – wound the clock, and I like that from an official. Hey, game's over. There's 2 minutes to go. There's no reason for me to stop the clock. Carmack brings him back out, second down and eight, right at the 24. Johnny looking him over. Here comes the defense on the right-hand side. Carmack going to keep it himself. Steps, goes back the other direction, dances the outside, goes up the middle, goes down just short of the 30-yard line.
Carmack on the keeper, brought down by number 34, Logan Baker.
And you watch Johnny again, goes out, he rolls out, nothing there, goes against the grain, dances back, turns the corner, and then goes down face first just to make sure he doesn't get hurt. This should be the last offensive play of the game.
And Mark, if they hand it off to Andre Carter up the middle, look at the defense playing up top,
yeah,
up tight.
If he breaks it.
Yeah.
Big third down and one. Letting the clock tick down as far as it can. They're down to 13 seconds. Hand it off to Carter. Up the middle, doesn't break it. And that should take us at the end of the game with 23 seconds to go and the clock ticking. It's the Hornets, 79, Grossmont 18. You've been watching this Fullerton College victory on SportsnetUSA.net. Want to thank everybody that made this game possible. Fullerton College TV, thank you very much for making this game possible. And now, Corey Neyland, we get ready to go because this game has come to an end. We've beaten the first team in conference play. You and I pack our bags next week, 6 o'clock. It's Saddleback on SportsnetUSA.net as your Hornets walk away with an outstanding victory, 79-18, here on SportsnetUSA.net in conjunction with Fullerton College TV.